Hello, and welcome to Loras College Rock Bowl. I'm Hugh Molony, and this is my co-anchor, EJ Greenberg. EJ, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Hugh. I'm ready for some Loras Duoc football.
Me too. We both know that there's a lot of talent out here in the Rock Bowl today, but there are always some players that seem to stand out a little bit more than the others. Who are you going to have your eyes on today?
Well, I think the number one player on the field for either team would be Eli Thomas. He missed all of last year, unfortunately, with a torn ACL, but as a freshman year, he's an All-American returner, so that's huge pickup back for the Duocs. Apparently, he has not lost a step, according to everyone at practice. He's just as fast, just as explosive as it used to be. And on defense, we want to keep an eye on Sam Jones and Jack Foley. They're both seniors, and Sam's a defensive end and probably one of the top pass rushers in the ARC. And Jack is a senior cornerback and might be the best corner in the conference. And both players are probably going to be locks to make all conference.
Yeah, I'm excited to see Eli bounce back from the torn ACL. You know what they say, you can't teach speed.
You cannot.
On the defensive side, I'm really looking forward to watching Sam affect the passing game. It should also be really fun to watch Jack lock up teams' receivers all season. And after all, defense does win championships. But enough about the Duhawks, EJ. Who do you think is going to be looking to take over this game for Northwestern?
Well, this Northwestern team is pretty young. You know, they only have seven seniors on the whole team. So it's going to be the guys who have some experience. Damon Clapper, the QB, he started 15 games in his career, which makes him one of the most experienced players for this team. And last year, he threw for 984 yards and seven touchdowns.
Sure sounds like it's going to be a tough day out there for both teams. Let's take it down to our sideline reporter, Adam Rodriguez. Adam, what do you have for us today? Trevor Lundberg
and Jeff Thomas. Thanks, guys. You can definitely feel the energy down here on the sideline, as this is the guys' first game in the Rock Bowl. For 510 days was the last time they were here in the Rock Bowl. Expect this game to be full of high intensity. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Adam. We'll check back in with you later. We've already highlighted a couple of players for today's game, but we both know that a football game is not won by just a couple of players. So let's take a look at our official starting lineups.
For Loras' offense at QB, he's been there for a couple of years now. Noah Sigworth, looking for a big game for him today. At running back, we got Eli Thomas and Ty Bosch, probably going to get an equal amount of carries. Mike McDevitt and Hunter Machi are going to be the tight end duo. Mike McDevitt last year was a wide receiver, so it'd be interesting to see how he plays at tight end. A wide receiver, we got Cabron Cook and Marty McGovern, two very good wide receivers, good hands, good speed, all around good wide receivers. In the slot, we got Javon Williams and Harrison Willis, probably equally going to spend time. None of them saw the field much last year, so the slot's really a young position for this team, so we'll look for them to step up today. At left tackle, we got Sean Corglass. Left guard, Ben Boffman. Center, Drew Blazekovic. Right guard, Derek Olcott. And right tackle, Drake Sorensen.
Thanks for the starting lineup, sir, EJ. And boy, I am just excited to get back to football. I feel like a kid on Christmas morning.
Yeah, it's great. It's great to finally be back in the stadium watching some live football. It's been too long. Way too long.
And it's nice that it's in the spring, because we had football and NFL and college football in like the fall, and now that we have it in the spring, and then we're going to get in the spring in the fall next year again too.
Yeah, it's going to be
nice.
Yeah, a lot of football in a short period.
Yeah,
can't ask for much more than that.
Nope, best sport there is, in my opinion.
I have to agree with you on that.
The kicker, Zachary Talbot. He's a freshman from Colorado. He'll be starting the season off for the Duhawks with the kick here.
You know what they call him, Hugh?
What do they call him?
Touchback Talbot.
Oh, okay. Let's see if he lives up to the name. Talbot with the kick, and we're off in the spring season for football. Oh, maybe not.
We're going to have to re-kick.
Yeah. Do you know what happened?
Maybe the refs. One of the refs wasn't ready, probably. Would be my guess.
Yeah, but like Adam said, it's been around 510 days since there's last been a game of football here in the Rock Bowl. That's just crazy to think about.
Way too long. Mm-hmm. Beautiful day for some football, too.
It is. A little bit chilly, but, you know, that's what you almost expect for a football season.
Yeah.
We have a great crowd on hand here today, too, for the first football game in a while here.
Yeah, it's a lot of fans showing up, showing their support for the D-Hawks. Great to see.
Glad to see that the rain held off for all these fans to come enjoy some football, too.
Yeah.
Okay, take two here for the opening kickoff of the season.
Touchback Talbot.
Zach with a almost like a squib kick here. It's picked up by Northwestern. Takes it out to around the 30, and he's tackled by a swarm of D-Hawks.
Really look for this D-Hawk defense to establish themselves early on. Last year, the defense did a great job. I believe they were number three in the nation for tackles for a loss, so that's really good. The D-line, that's the one thing that's changed a lot, though. They lost three starters from last year, so hopefully they can step up this year.
Clapper in the shotgun formation. Getting the play call in from his coach there. Oh. A pass here for Northwestern. Picks up around 7 yards there. That's a nice way for them to start the game.
Good tackle there by Zacchaeus Knighton.
Always good to see players be able to make those one-on-one tackles in the open field.
Yeah.
Turns out it's Ryan Flanagan at quarterback. I apologize for that. He's in the shotgun formation again. Wide receiver in motion. They hand it off to the running back. And he's met at the line by D-Hawk Josh Jones. That was a nice stop there in the backfield for Josh.
Yeah, the Jones brother is going to be a big part of this defense this year. Last year, Sam, we're rotating out. Josh didn't get as much playing time as I think he'd want. But this year, both Jones brothers are going on the field for almost every play.
Nice, nice. Big third down here already at the start of the game. It'd be huge momentum here for the D-Hawks to get a stop. Shotgun, little screen pass here. D-Hawks, they're blown up, stopped at the line. That's a great defensive possession there to start the game off for the D-Hawks.
Yeah, defense coordinator Greg Bauer is going to love that. He always preaches running to the ball, and that's what they did right there, rally to the attack point. Not the best throw from Flanagan for that screen, but good job rallying to the ball, yeah, for the D-Hawks.
That's just a nice way to see a season start off for a defense, is a nice 3-and-out. KJ Downey here with the punt. It's off to Eli Thomas, but it's going to be checked up there by Northwestern.
I'd imagine Northwestern's probably not going to want to kick Eli Thomas.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd want to kick it to him either.
All American returners, freshman year. Mm-hmm. Very dangerous.
Yeah. I'm excited to see this D-Hawk offense come out here and see how Noah Sigworth's going to perform here to start it off.
Yeah, he had set the single season rushing record for quarterbacks last year in Loras history. Maybe not the best season passing-wise compared to his amazing sophomore season, but he's going to be a huge part of this D-Hawk offense this year. Huge.
Shotgun formation here for the D-Hawks. Thomas in motion. Sigworth on the option keeps it, and he's blown up behind the line by Northwestern.
Yeah, they're going to get Eli Thomas around the ball. If not give him the ball, he's going to be in motion. He's going to, because the defense is going to follow him. Yeah, defense knows this guy's got dangerous speed. They're going to be all over him.
Yeah. Sigworth in shotgun again. Hands it off to the running back. He's making a cut up the field. Nice little solid gain of 4 yards there by Ty Bosch.
Great run right there by Ty.
He had 6 touchdowns last season.
Yeah, amazing freshman year. Amazing freshman year. Rushing
attempt by number 21. He just has a nice build for like a running back that you want. 39-yard
line. He's Dolores Christian McCaffrey. He can do it all. He can run. He can catch.
A quick third down here for the D-Hawks. Now let's see if they can not go 3-and-out like their opponents here. Sigworth throws an interception here on his first drive, and Northwestern will take over on the D-Hawk 45.
Not a great start for the D-Hawk offense.
No. Looks like that pass was a little bit forced, maybe.
Yeah.
But just hope the defense can do what they did last drive and get another quick 3-and-out.
Surprised we didn't see Eli get a touch.
Yeah. Kind of figured they might may have given it to him when Sigworth kept it, but maybe he saw something to keep it instead of giving it up.
Making his reads.
Northwestern passes incomplete, knocked down by
Jack Foley.
By Jack Foley.
Huge player.
The player to watch, yeah. Jack Foley.
He's going to be on these receivers like glue all game. Jack Foley, calling it now, lock for all conference. Okay. About to have a huge year.
Revis Island, more like Foley Island, yes, sir, out there.
His younger brother, Joey, too, would have been starting opposite of him, but unfortunately, he's out for the season.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's always sad to hear. Northwestern with a deep pass over the middle. The Ryan Flanagan overthrows his receiver. Another quick third down here for Northwestern.
Good coverage there by Duox, Zach Kemp right there.
It's always just, so far the Duox have been smothering on the passing game.
Yeah.
Besides that first play where they got 7 yards, but they haven't got anything since then. Flanagan in the shotgun again. He gets the snap, fakes the handoff, and he's absolutely obliterated there by Duhawk, by the Duhawks there. Just a great play.
Kiefer.
That's a great play there by Josh Kiefer. Just run through there and hit the quarterback.
They brought the house and they got him. He had no time.
I know. That's it's always fun to see them come in with like a heat-seeking missiles, almost, yeah, like he came in there. Like
that Duhawk defense is going to bring a lot of pressure.
Mm-hmm.
With blitzes and off the edge, they have great pass rushers, even without the blitz.
It's always fun to see a nice pass rush game.
Yeah.
Ty Bosch is back there now for the Duhawks on the punt return. He's just going to let this one bounce. And a great punt there by K.J. Doyle, and that ball will be marked up on the one-yard,
wow,
line, it looks like.
Great punt. Had some great great bounces there.
Yeah,
there, too.
That was a great punt.
Yeah.
Northwestern with the punt. The ball is so, in order for the Duhawks to score here, they're almost going to have to go, they're going to have to go 99 yards almost, basically.
Yeah.
For a touchdown.
It's going to start with the guys up front.
Mm-hmm.
They have a younger offensive line compared to last year due to injuries. So, they got one freshman, two sophomores. One of them played a little bit, the other one not so much. And then Derek Olcott and Drew Blazekovic are going to nail it down. They've been there for a while.
It's always nice to have the young kids there with the veterans, if you will.
Yeah.
Duhawks throwing the ball here on their own 1 yard line. They're getting a nice amount of space there, about 5 yards.
Eli's first touch.
Number 16, Elijah Thomas.
I almost think they're going to have to really work it to him now after last drive when he didn't touch it and they went 3 and out. Sigworth in the pistol formation here. He gets the snap. Eli with it. Oh, makes a nice cut. I don't know how we got through there. Nice run there by Eli Thomas. Pick up the first down and give the Duhawks even more room.
It's just like he disappears in the pile and then comes out on the other end untouched.
I thought it was going to be a no game, but then he broke it for like 15 yards. That was honestly amazing.
The talent of Eli Thomas.
Sigworth in the shotgun again with Bosch in the backfield, hands it off. Oh, no, he fakes the handoff and he takes it for himself, gaining about 4 yards there.
I think motion is going to be a big part. We've seen it twice already, yeah, with Eli on the option.
That's what happens when you have a guy with such speed and such talent. He's going to draw a lot of attention.
I tell you what, Eli Thomas and Ty Bosch together is like Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt. It's,
yeah,
a deadly running back combination. Mm-hmm.
Sigworth hands it off to Bosch. Bosch makes a cut in the backfield. He's still fighting. Gets maybe a yard. It was a good job by him to make that cut and not get tackled for a loss.
That was a great one-yard run right there.
It was.
He almost had no time. He almost got tackled right when he got the ball.
Yeah. That's just a good job by him to make the cut and avoid the defender. So, Duhawks have yet to throw the ball in this drive. I almost think they're going to have to throw it here.
Third and about four, yeah. I'd guess so.
Sigworth drops back. He's scrambling. Sigworth pulled down there for a sack by number
19,
who is
Damon
Clapper.
Position change.
Yeah, we had him at quarterback. He switched over to a defensive end.
Wow.
Interesting.
Guy can do it all.
Yeah. Punter Nicholas Farfan for the Duhawks is out there right now. And it looks like he's got a little bit of a breeze at his back. So maybe the ball probably travel a little bit farther.
Yeah.
Nicholas's punt is downed at the 39 for the Duhawks.
Oh, still rolling.
Kept rolling. About the 37.
It was
a solid punt. That was a great job by the offense to get at least away from their own goal line to at least somewhat flip the field position.
Yeah, absolutely.
So far, it's been all defense.
Yeah.
Hoping to maybe see some points get thrown up here.
Let's see a defensive score. Come on.
Pick six?
Yeah.
That'd be pretty.
Scoop and score?
Nice.
Strip sack?
Either, yeah. Flanagan in the shotgun. Hands it off to the running back. He's brought down after getting a two by Duhawks. That was a great job to stop him from getting up any farther there. Good job containing him.
I think that was the Wellborn brothers in the interior getting the stop right there.
A lot of brothers on this Duhawk football team.
The Wellborns are twins, and I'll tell you what, I don't know if I've ever met a stronger pair of brothers in my life. When you see them in the weight room, they're moving serious weight.
It's a lot of big boys up there.
Yeah, yeah.
Flanagan gets it, dumps it out to his receiver, and he's met in the backfield, but he breaks the tackle and gets a gain of about 1 yard.
Flanagan's pass complete.
He evaded the first defender there, but he was met about by three more Duhawks a yard later.
See the pass rushers come on in for the third and long, trying to get a sack.
I think they're going to drop back into zone here.
What's that?
Think they're going to drop back into zone here?
Oh, yeah, I guess so, right around the markers.
Zone blitz, yeah. Flanagan, pressured. He's got to scramble out. He dumps it off to his receiver, KJ. Dumps off to KJ Downey, who is short of the marker. Another quick three and out here for the.
I'm not getting sound.
For the Duhawks. There's a penalty called, and the Duhawks declined it, so it'll be fourth down.
Another punt. A lot of punts here early on.
Yeah. About what? Two, three and outs for both teams to start off this game?
This is the third one.
This is their third.
Yeah.
Duhawks are two. KJ Downey with the punt to Ty Bosch, who catches it over the head. Gets a block thrown for him, but there's a flag. It'll be a block in the back.
Yeah.
Ty Bosch just keeps going.
Great return, though.
Sadly, it's going to be called back for an illegal block in the back.
Yeah.
So the first points of the board for the Duhawks are going to get wiped away on a illegal block in the back by number six for the Duhawks.
I believe that is Zacchaeus Knight. Yeah.
Just hate to see it. But we knew right away when we saw it.
I think that block was probably a block that allowed Ty to get that far downfield. Looked like he had a pretty good angle on him.
Yeah. As you can see on this replay here, Ty was just cruising away from the defenders there.
Yeah. He did a great job of changing speeds there, tiptoeing on the sideline and cutting back through the field and running by everyone.
Yeah.
This shows you how dynamic of a player Ty really is.
Always good to have those dynamic guys all that can do everything. So last season, I believe, was Loras' best record in a while, 5-5.
Yeah, it was. Still disappointing because there's a lot of games they felt they could have won. They were in till the very end, and just one big mistake, I should say, caused a loss.
But it's always good to see improvement year in and year out. Sigworth's pass is completed to his receiver, and
Sigworth's
first pass completion of the season.
It's to Javon Williams, the freshman.
Freshman.
First college catch there.
It's a big one. Yeah. Sigworth's first of the season, I believe, with his first completion, too.
Yeah.
Sigworth hands it off to – oh, no, he fakes the handoff. Duhok's trying to make a guy miss, and unfortunately couldn't make him miss, and he's tackled for about no gain.
I believe that was tight end Hunter Machi. Yep.
Another third down here for the Duhawks. Let's see if they can pick it up here. Sigwart's in the backfield with Eli. Eli has the ball, fights for it. I think he got the first down.
He got move the chains. Gotta keep feeding that man the ball.
He's picked up the only first downs for the Duhawks, I believe, so far in this game.
Yeah.
Sigworth gets the play in from the sideline. He gets the snap. Fakes the handoff to Eli. Throwing it across the middle. Almost intercepted.
That was a good play by Machi. Just get his hands on the ball so it wasn't an interception.
Almost a little bit forced there is what that one seemed like.
Mm-hmm. Intended receiver was number
15, Ty Bosch checks back into the game in the backfield for Eli Thomas.
If this Duhawk offense needs to get going, they need to give Siggy a little more time in the pocket and also maybe some open receivers, and Siggy needs to maybe try scrambling or something new besides forcing the pass because it's not been working so far.
Yeah, keep the defenders on their toes.
Yeah.
Oh, good read there by Siggy to keep the ball. Penalty flag on the ground. Siggy takes it around to the 40-yard line and knocked out of bounds.
You see how athletic Siggy was on that play. You see why he's so important to this team, because he make big plays like that. He can make them with his arms or with his legs.
That was a great read there by Sigworth to keep the ball.
Yeah, he kept it to the last second.
I didn't see on the replay here. Ty gets tackled, and Siggy keeps the ball, and then he just runs away from all the defenders. But there was a flag on the play.
Holding. Right back to the offensive line.
Yeah. But maybe now Sigworth will have some confidence and he'll be able to turn it on. Keep the defense on their toes now that he's scrambling a little bit more.
Yeah.
Out wide for the Duhawks is number 4, Cabrin Cook. In the backfield, number 21, Ty Bosch and Noah Sigworth. Bosch on the right side of Sigworth. Whistle's blown.
Another stop in the action.
Yeah. Rest moving the ball. Second and long here. Sigworth gets the snap. Looking deep. Sees nothing. He moves out of the pocket. Throws it. Another interception.
Did he drop it?
I think he dropped it.
Wow.
Almost Sigworth's second interception of the game here with 5 minutes to go left here in the first.
I think he's forcing it still. I think he should have just taken off, got the yards he could have, move on, live another play.
As you can see here, he's scrambling out. Doesn't really set his feet when he throws it, and then the defender just jumps the route.
Yeah.
Good job there by Marty McGrovin to bring up the interception.
Yeah.
Eli Thomas in the backfield now. Sigworth steps up. He gets a block. Trucks a defender.
Oh.
Looking like a running back out there. Jeez.
Great run by Siggy. You know, that's the thing about Siggy. He's a great leader. And he'll run someone over. That'll get the guys fired up. When you see your quarterback not afraid to get his nose dirty, get in there, throw a block maybe, run someone over, it gets the guys fired up, and they want to play harder for the quarterback.
Almost got the first down, too, just about 4 yards short of it. Farfan out there to punt for the Duhawks again.
Game of field position so far.
It is, yeah. Farfan's punt is up. Northwestern Fair catches it, and they'll take over at their own 43-yard line.
Yeah.
Nick Farfan with the punt for Loras. A fair catch by
number 8, Caleb Stephen. Let's see what the Duhawk defense has planned for this drive.
First down for the Eagles at the 44-yard line.
Hopefully they keep playing as well they have been playing.
Yeah.
Correction, 43-yard line.
Duhawks missing their top 7 leading tacklers from last year, so some guys are going to need to step up, but I think we got the right guys to fill their shoes.
Always hurts to lose a bunch of upperclassmen who are big key players in your defense.
Yeah.
Northwestern sends a man in motion. They hand it off to their running back, and he's blown up about 3 yards after the line. Good stop there by the Duhawks. I believe that was Jack Foley. Is that who made that tackle? I saw him come out from that area.
They're saying Kiefer. I thought it was Eli Dirtz. So all three of us are all on the different pages right now. The freshman Eli Dirtz, though, number 97, maybe the strongest human being I've met in my life. He's a power lifter. He wins a whole bunch of events.
Oh, gosh. Flanagan forced up in the pocket. Dumps it off to KJ Doyle. Oh, Doyle on the move. Downey, and he's brought down at the Duhawks' own 8-yard line.
Seemed like they ran a little screen pass right there. All the defensive linemen had a shot at him. He stepped up, got right by him.
As you can see here, KJ Downey on the run, and he's brought down by the Duhawks. A nice touchdown-saving tackle right there on the 10-yard line.
Yeah, great play there by Patrick Suddy.
Flanagan with another throw. Great tackle, though, on the open field there on that one-on-one.
It's Brett Bauer.
Me and Brett Bauer went to high school together.
Really?
Yeah. He's a year older than me.
He used to be my roommate.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Yeah. So it looks like we all have connections to Brett here on the broadcast.
Tackled at the 6-yard line, second and goal.
Turnover would be huge right here for the Duhawks.
I think that really swing the momentum here. Flanagan in the backfield with James. Flanagan drops back, throws it up into the corner. No good. KJ Downey couldn't bring it in.
It's going to be tough to bring it in when Foley's guarding you.
Flanagan's
pass incomplete, intended for KJ Downey. Third and goal for the Eagles.
It's always good to know you have that one cornerback you can always rely on to shut down the team's number one receiver.
Oh, absolutely. Corner and a pass rusher, those are two biggest things.
Dangerous combo.
Yeah.
Flanagan and James in the backfield together again. Wide receiver in motion. Flanagan fakes the handoff to the running back, throws it up in the back of the end zone. I believe he caught it and they ruled a touchdown. He was in bounds.
That was a great play.
That was a nice catch. Nice catch by Caleb Seabin.
You know, I don't think the Duhawks are really sure what kind of offense they're going to see, considering he's a new offensive coordinator for the Eagles. So we're going to see a replay here.
As you can see, Flanagan rolling out here. And he gets hit right as he throws it, but just once again, a nice catch there by Caleb Seabin.
That was a great throw, too. Threw it where only his guy could catch it.
Yeah. And on the run, too, right as he got hit.
That was a dot.
Oh, the extra point is blocked. And they run it in, but no 2-point conversion.
Yep, the ball is dead.
Yep.
Blake Mitchell's extra point is blocked.
Come on, Duhawks, just get the offense going here.
Yeah. It'd be really tough here for the Duhawks to be shut out here for the whole first quarter.
Yeah. Really, the only big play so far for the Eagles has been that screen pass, and that's about it.
Yeah, got them down in the position to score.
Yeah.
So, like we've talked about before, the young offensive line and how important the offensive line is. How do you think they'll be performing throughout the season?
Well, it's game one, so there's probably gonna be some nerves there, especially with the younger guys. But look at the swing of things. This is the first quarter, you know, quarter, first season. Get right back into it. Mm-hmm. There's some big boys.
Yeah. It's all about improving from each snap, honestly. Yeah.
They got great senior leadership in their center, Drew Blazekovich.
Always good to have that senior anchor.
Yep. Call him Blaze. He's a good leader. Especially when the leader of your line is the center. It's always good.
Yeah. Blake Mitchell kicking off here for Northwestern. Bosch and Eli Thomas are back to receive it. The kick is up, and Eli Thomas receives it. Eli Thomas waiting for his block to set up. Oh, he's got a hole. Eli Thomas, tackled at the around the 50-yard line. That was a nice return there from Eli. I thought he was about to break it for a touchdown.
Absolutely. Every time Eli Thomas has the ball in his hands, the fans are on the edge of their seat.
I believe there was a flag during the play, too. Here's a replay of Eli. He just really good patience by him to wait for the cuts to set up. And then almost broke it free, but that was a nice tackle there by Northwestern. And then I believe I saw a flag being thrown there at the end.
It looks like they're discussing it.
As it stands right now, the ball is on Northwestern's 47-yard line. A sportsmanlike penalty called there on number 47 for the Duhawks, Brett McWilliams. Those are just the penalties as a coach. I'm assuming you just can't stand.
Yeah, that's killer. You're on the other side of the field, finally flipped field position.
Getting a momentum,
yeah,
and then you just go and do something like that.
It's all right, though. If Eli in the ball, mm-hmm. or Eli with Eli's hands on the ball, mistakes get erased quickly.
Yeah. I haven't seen the Duhawks go. I haven't seen any of these teams do anything but shotgun so far.
Mm-mm. No under center.
Sigworth and Bosch in the backfield. Thomas is in motion. Sigworth keeps it on the read option.
Oh,
is he down?
The ball did come out.
The ball did come out. I don't know if he was down or not yet. I believe they're saying he's down.
Let's take a look here at the replay.
It's another great read by Sigworth there to keep the ball and make a few guys miss.
With the keeper.
Oh, that was really
close.
His knee might have been down, but that would have been it.
Another read option here, given off to Bosch this time. He fights forward for a tough yard.
Did he get it? Oh, he got it.
Oh, that was a nice hard run right there by Ty Bosch.
Number 21, Ty Bosch. Results of the play is a Duhawk first down.
Almost feel like the Duhawks are going to speed up the pace here with how they're moving the ball right now.
Yeah, trying to get something going.
Oh, switching the balls
ball
out.
The field.
Sigworth and Bosch in the backfield once again. Sigworth gets the snap, throws it out to Bosch. Ty going up the field. Nice hard run there by Ty.
Wow. I don't know how he made that guy miss. He just outran him. He wanted it more. He had a great angle at him.
Yeah. That was a great block there on the sideline, too, by, I believe, Cabron Cook.
Yeah.
I believe that's who that was. That was a good block.
Yeah, Cabron, a big, strong receiver, great at blocking.
I always like to see receivers who don't mind blocking and getting their hands dirty in there. Sigworth gets the snap, fakes the pass, gets it to Cook. Cook runs, gets a nice little gain of about 7 yards there. Just speak of the man.
Yeah.
Reward him for that good block.
Yeah, you get your nose dirty, get you the rock.
Yeah.
Sigworth's pass complete.
Cabron Cook is one of those guys who's almost posed to have a breakout year.
Yeah, yeah. I'd say so. He's definitely going to be the number one wide receiver. Penalty down on the field.
I believe they threw that ball to Cabron Cook again, too.
First down for the Duhawks.
Penalty declined. Minute 24 here to go left in the first quarter, and the Duhawks are driving down the field.
I had to say, the all purple for the Duhawks looks pretty sharp.
I like it.
The Eagles' uniforms, too, are pretty nice, I would say.
Mm-hmm. Sigworth alone in the shotgun. Gets the snap, looking over, throws it to his big tight end for the touchdown. Touchdown by Hunter Machi.
Hunter Machi.
That was a nice pass there. That was a nice pass there by Sigworth to his big tight end.
Yeah. Good work, boys.
As you can see here, Sigworth gets the ball, does a nice quick step back, and hits his man wide open in the end zone.
Yeah, I think Machi just ran a quick little post right there.
What is this? Interesting formation here for the Duhawks.
We have Farfan and Sigworth in the backfield. Oh, now they're motioning back. I would have loved to see Farfan get a handoff. That would have been awesome.
That formation was interesting, to say the least, to start it.
Yeah. Can they get the snap off? They do.
Farfan's kick is up, and it's good. Duhawks take the lead here with the 1:08 left to go here in the first.
That blocked extra point might turn out to be huge.
Yeah. And Sigworth's big tight end, 6'5", 245. That's a hard dude to almost miss there.
Yeah. Machi, great tight end. Very athletic, very strong.
Yeah.
Good hands, everything you want from a tight end. Mm-hmm.
So, ladies and gentlemen, that is your Duhawks' first touchdown of the spring 2021 season, and gives them the lead here with 1:08 left to go in the first.
Touchback Talbot.
Let's see something.
I bet they're probably going to squib it again like they did last time. Here in the first.
Zach's kick is up. Oh, just a booming kick by Zach. Northwestern's going to return it. Oh,
and he lost the ball. Oh, and the Duhawks have the ball. Duhawk football.
That's a great strip tackle.
Oh, there
right
is
there.
A flag. There is a flag down, but I doubt this one's coming back. So covered by number 11. Dawson Charlie.
Here's the replay, ladies and gentlemen. Just a good hustle play there to knock that ball free. And just landed right in the lap of...
Who's that? Number 68?
Of Dawson.
Return team. It's Michael Wellborn punching that one out, I believe. Great play, especially by the D lineman. Be the first one down there punching that out. That's what you love to see.
Yeah, that was an exciting play, too.
Yeah.
And the penalty on Northwestern moves the Duhawks even closer to their own end zone.
All the momentum on the Duhawks side right now.
Another score here would be huge.
Yeah. No, that was number 69, I believe, that forced the fumble, Justin Apple.
Oh, getting a little chippy down there, it looks like.
Noah Sigworth with the keeper, a loss of one.
Sigworth
on the
isn't happy about something that
ball
happened
is at
down
the
9-yard
there. Line, second and goal.
Ty comes out of the game, and Eli moves over to the backfield, it looks like. Think they're going to look for Hunter here again in the end zone?
I wouldn't be surprised.
I'm thinking either him or Cabrin because they're your two tallest receivers almost.
Cabrin's a great red zone threat. He's a jump ball receiver. He can do it all, run by you, go over you.
Sigworth gets the snap, looking for a pass. Throws it to Cabrin.
Touchdown.
Speak of the man. I think they're just hearing us talking about
him.
Yeah,
I think
we
should say his name every play because every play something good happens.
Yeah. That was a nice route and throw there by both those guys. Let's take another look at this one, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, Sigworth with the snap. Gets that ball out of his hand relatively fast, and then Cabron was just wide open in the end zone.
Yeah.
Hopefully Duox can take a 15-point lead here. Kick is up. And it's good again. Nicholas Farfan.
There is a flag.
Oh. But Nicholas Farfan last year did go 30 for 31 on his PAT, so pretty reliable kicker.
Automatic, I would say.
Yeah. Duox is going to decline this penalty, it looks like.
All the momentum on Duox's side going in the second quarter. That's huge.
Duox going to have an 8-point lead here unless something happens going in here on the kickoff into the second quarter. Hopefully another play like last kickoff happens again. That'd be huge.
Amazing. Touchback Talbot.
It was outcast this whole time we were setting up, and now the sun's starting to come out a little bit.
Yeah. Beautiful night here at the Rock Bowl.
It is a beautiful night. Football with it, too, makes it even better.
Nothing better.
Zach kicks it off. Another deep kick. They're going to fair catch it this time. Don't want to risk turning it over again here.
I think you pictured big Justin Apple running down, punching the ball out.
Give him a little PTSD almost.
Yeah. All the momentum on the Duox side right now. See if the Eagles can get something going.
I think they're almost going to have to get it into KJ Downey's hands again. He seems like their go-to guy here.
Yeah.
Flanagan, the pistol formation. Hands it off to James. James makes a cut, but goes nowhere with it as he stopped at the line of scrimmage. I don't know if another play will be ran off here before the end of the quarter.
Doesn't look like it.
No gain on the play. Second and 10.
But down by a plethora of Duox right there.
That's Carter.
At the end of the first quarter, your Loras Duox 14, Northwestern Eagles 6.
Early on, wasn't really looking too good for the Duox. A couple turnovers. Probably could have been a couple more, honestly.
Yeah.
But then that one big play that's really turned everything around. Yeah. Machi's touchdown followed by that punch and scoop.
This break almost might be good for Northwestern to have the maybe slow down the momentum a little bit.
Yeah. Slow down the Duhawks' heart rate.
So, like we talked about earlier, Sigworth has a he's going to have a big season coming off of not a great season as a sophomore and a junior year. What do you think his presence and importance for the team is?
Well, Siggy's the leader of this team, no doubt. You can ask any player on this Loras football team. They love Siggy. Siggy's the guy. He has great legs, there's no question. He can run the ball. Can he get the ball to his guys when they need to? He has a ton of talent on this team. As long as he can get the time up front and he doesn't force throws, that's the one thing. Sometimes he'll just force a throw when he doesn't need to. He's a great quarterback, great talent. So if he performs like he did his sophomore year, I'd say, Duox could go 5-0.
Mm-hmm. I was thinking, already, even though it's the first game, I've already seen some flashes that he can be good this season.
Yeah.
Northwestern motions a man over. They fake the handoff to their running back. Throwing it up. Overthrows his receiver, KJ Downey. And no Duox in the area.
Good pressure right there from Brett McWilliams coming off the edge.
It's almost like Flanagan hasn't had any time. He's always been moved around the pocket, hasn't been able to sit in there. Oh, Another third down here for the Eagles. Duhok defense has been great up to this point. Oh, he's pressured again in the pocket, and he throws it away.
He's lucky to even get that off. Yeah. That's almost a strip sack. Mm-hmm.
Just great defense once again there by the front line for the Duhok defense. I was thinking it might have been intentional grounding, and then the ref threw the flag.
After a bit of convincing from the coaches.
Mm-hmm. So I didn't think he was out of the pocket, and I just didn't see the flag thrown, so I didn't know if it was like the angle or something.
Yeah. Another punt here for the Eagles.
KJ Downey shows it all for this team. He's the punter and maybe their best player on offense, too. Ty's back for the Duhawks, and he's going to be receiving this punt.
Saw how dangerous Ty was, and he actually caught one. Let's see.
Mm-hmm. Let's see if they even want to kick it to him.
Yeah. Now this Loras offense is excited to get back onto the field.
I think if they score again on offense, they might just run away with this one with the momentum that they're going to be having.
Yeah.
Downey's punts away. Bit of a wobbler. Ty catches it. Makes the first man miss. Breaking it off to the sideline. Nice little stiff arm by Ty, but the defender stays with them, and there's another flag on the field.
It's a great job right there by number 44, I believe. There's a flag actually not. Cameron Kopic.
Good job by him to, as you can see,
the stiff arm.
Ty coming off his pad got pulled out of his jersey on the tackle.
Another holding.
Holding on the Duhawks there. So far on almost every punt return, there's been a penalty on the Duhawks.
Yeah, a lot of penalties early on. Some declined, some not. It's Josh Oglesby on the hold.
So the last time the Duhawks and Northwestern Eagles play was 1986. And EJ, I got some questions for you.
All right, let's see.
It's about the price of things in 1986. How much do you think a gallon of gas in 1986 costed?
Ooh. $2.
93 cents.
Holy.
Meanwhile, Eli Thomas runs it up there for a first down for the Duhawks.
Great run right there.
Mm-hmm. Got another one. How much do you think a movie ticket costed?
Oh, movie ticket. Let's see, how much is a movie ticket now? I haven't been because of COVID.
Yeah.
I think it was like 10 or 12 bucks, so I'm going to go five.
$2.75.
$2.75, wow.
Sigworth fakes the handoff to Thomas, keeps it himself. Makes a man miss. He's moving up the sideline. He's got a hole. Oh, flag thrown. Might be a hold call on Cabron Cook there.
By Noah great block Sigworth. By Sean Cordulis right there.
Oh, there's a couple flags on the field.
Both of them might be on the Duhawks.
Yeah.
Oh, yep, it was on Sean.
That was a nice run there by Sigworth to take it up there and make a couple guys miss.
Yeah. Seems like every time this Duhawk offense takes a couple steps forward to take a couple back.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of self-imposed errors so far.
Yeah. And as a coach, I'm sure you just hate to have those penalties on a big game like that and moves you back.
Yeah. Wait, how much was gas in 1986?
93 cents.
Wow.
I know, right?
Wow.
Sigworth fixed the handoff to Thomas, gets it to his receivers, run up the field, gets a block.
Harrison Willis.
Gain of about 20 yards there for a first down. That was a nice play there.
That was Javon, excuse me.
The freshman.
Yeah.
Making plays already. Love to see that out of a young guy.
He's pushed out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Second down.
Young slot receiver.
I know it's crazy to think gas was 93 cents back then for a gallon.
Wow.
Especially with it's like $3 now or something like that. Yeah. Pretty close to it. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Sigworth in the pistol formation with Ty behind him. gives it up to Ty. Ty knocks a man over, still fighting, gets blown up behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of about 3 or 4.
Ty didn't really have a chance there.
No. It was a good job by him to run that first guy over.
He bulldozed that first guy. That first guy stood no chance tackling him.
Yeah. Just met by a swarm of Eagles after that.
It looked like Derrick Henry right there.
Yeah, he did. And that stiff arm he had earlier on the punt return, too. Maybe he's been watching his Derrick Henry film. Sigworth gets the snap. Looks like it was a design QB run. He keeps it up. I believe he has enough for the first down. He keeps fighting, and he for sure has it.
Siggy's always going to fight for those extra yards.
Sigworth with the keeper. Result of the play is a Loras College.
That was a nice QB designed run there. The Duhawks' big red zone threat tight end Hunter has come back into the game here, along with, I believe, Cabron Cook is also out there. So your two big red zone threats in the red zone, that's where you need them at.
Yep. I think they're going double tight end, too.
Run play, you thinking, then? Double tight end?
I'd assume so. Motion to the right.
Oh Sigworth fakes the handoff. Throwing it. Oh, intercepted. Overthrew his big target there a little bit, and Sigworth's second interception of the game.
I think that was another forced one.
Yeah, I think it was too. I think he felt the pressure coming and thought he had to get rid of it.
See here on the replay.
First down for the Eagles.
As you can see here, their pass rush gets in Sigworth's face, and the first Eagles defender tipped it up, and then his teammate was right there behind him to finish the job.
Yeah. Tough break for the Duhawks.
Maybe now the momentum might switch back into the Eagles' favor here. Eagles motion a man over. Flanagan fakes the handoff to his running back, gets to the receiver. His receiver, ooh, good job there by the Duhawks. I believe Brett Bauer to knock the man out of bounds for the
Flanagan's
Eagles.
Pass complete to number 8.
Thought he
Caleb
was going
to
keep running for a while there. Great play by Brett, forcing out of bounds.
Because Caleb Sieben, number 80, who that made that play, looks like he has some good wheels, too.
Looks like you running out there, Hugh.
Oh, in the glory days. I believe those days are past my time now. Flanagan forced by the pressure again, and he throws it away.
Receiver is Sieben, third down.
Going after, looking for Sieben again.
Steelhawk defense not giving the Eagles anything.
No. Which is always looking good, too, for the rest of the season as
well. Yeah, absolutely.
Because you know when you have a good defense, you can always rely on them if the offense maybe can't get it going for a game or something like that. Sieben motioned again. This time the handoff to the running back, James, who was absolutely met, obliterated behind the line by a swarm of Duhawks.
I believe Marcus Lampley got to him first, and Chance Hatfield cleaned it up. Chance? Another great defensive end this Duhawk team has. He's also a senior.
It's always nice when you have the good defensive line to hold in the trenches.
Battle of the trenches is always usually where the game's won. Mm-hmm. Ty Bosch back to return. Whistles blow. Gonna redo it.
So Northwestern last year, I believe they was a okay year for them.
Yeah, they're 4-6. Their one matchup against an ARC team was against Central, where I believe they lost 42-12. When the Duhawks played Central last year, the score was, I believe, 55-33, 52-33, somewhere around there.
Yeah, and they got a new offensive coordinator this year, too, I believe. So maybe working out some of the kinks with the first game with the new offensive coordinator. Another whistle is blown.
They're going to go back even farther.
Sorry.
It's almost like the Eagles are playing defense on themselves here.
Yeah. Duke should have pretty good field position here.
KJ Downey will be punting it here for the Eagles as ties back to receiver.
Oh! High snap.
High snap. Oh! And just, he gets a good bounce.
Lucky break there for the Eagles.
That was crazy that he was able to keep that ball in bounds. By the way, he punted it, it's like almost like it was coming right at us.
That was a great athletic.
Yeah.
Great athletic play right there.
Almost thought the Duhawks were going to blow it up for a safety, man.
The Eagles is down at the 48-yard line. First down for Loras College.
Even a touchdown. Some Duhawk offense. Let's get going here.
I believe the pass there by Sigworth was incomplete, looked a little wobbly.
Sigworth's pass is incomplete, broken up by number 39, Daryl Miles.
Loras needs to get something going in here, put this game away.
They're really letting the Eagles hang around them right now. The
game's just kind of hanging in the balance, waiting for someone to take it right now.
Yeah, it is. Eli has the ball, makes a man miss, turning up the field, and he's met by number 19, Damon Clapper.
Great move right there by Eli.
That was. Such a small guy, easy to make people miss. 5'7", 175 pounds. Third down and four here for the Duhawks. Sigworth and Thomas in the backfield. Sigworth gets the snap. Looking, gets it to his big tight end, Hunter. Hunter gets brought down. After a first down gain, good to see Sigworth hitting those check downs. Yeah. Get the confidence up a little bit after the interception.
Yeah, no, don't force anything. Just get the first down. Keep the chains moving. Mm-hmm.
Sigworth and Thomas remain in the backfield together. Almost think they're going to try and get it to Eli here. Nope. Screen pass.
Javon
runs into his blocker after a solid gain of 5 yards.
Sigworth's pass caught by number 8, Javon Williams.
A lot of targets so far for the freshman.
Glad as a freshman, that's got to be a reassurance that your senior quarterback leader is targeting you in your first collegiate game.
He trusts you enough.
Mm-hmm. Pistol formation now here for the Duhawks. It's been this and the shotgun all game for him. Thomas has the ball. He gets a hole. And he keeps pushing his feet, and he takes four Eagle defenders to bring him down there.
The one thing about Eli, he does weigh 175 pounds, but he's a strong kid. He puts up big numbers in the weight room. Yeah. It's going to take more than one guy to bring him down, usually.
Always good to have that in running back that keep their legs pushing and turning.
Mm-hmm.
Ty checked back into the game now for Eli. Sigworth gets the ball, throws up to Ty on a check down. Ty makes a man miss. Oh,
Ty.
Oh, he's still on his feet. Wow, nice play there by Ty to get a solid gain of about 12 yards.
You see the dynamic duo the Loras has. They bring one stud on the field, or they take one stud off the field, bring one stud on.
Here's a replay of that last amazing play there by Ty. As you can see, makes the first man miss with a nice juke. And then he just reads his block. And then he just stays on his feet with that nice spin move to gain more yards. Just a great presence of mind there by Ty.
Ty and Eli are both similar, and they can outrun you, and they can run through you.
Mm-hmm.
Ty is more of a change of speed, change of pace guy. Eli's just going to outrun you.
Yeah. Triple option here. Sigworth keeps it for himself. Runs it in the end zone for a touchdown.
Great fake and great cut right there by Siggy.
Yeah, that was a great play by Sigworth. He's fired up in the end zone, too, after that nice run. Another look here. Moving them in formation to set up the option play. just a nice read there by Sigurd on defenders, then being able to make guys miss and get into the end zone. Just a great play overall. Farfan's kick is up, right down the middle.
Automatic.
Uh-huh.
Extra point by number 33, Nick Farfan, is good.
I like the headband Farfan's rocking.
Yeah. Kickers have swag, too.
Oh, yeah. Got to respect it.
Yeah. Could see touchback Talbot back at it.
Kicking into the wind this time.
Yeah.
The wind's picked up a little bit, too, since the start of the game. The flag's moving a little bit more. Breeze, it's making it a little bit chilly out here today, but not too bad.
Nothing Duoc fans aren't used to.
Nope.
Got it watching all these kickoffs. The guy who made the big play on the fumble, mm-hmm. number 69, Justin Apple.
Yeah.
Plays offensive line. Last year played defensive line. Always a stud on kickoff.
And he
kickoff
was moving, play. Too, for a guy of his size.
Yeah.
Oh, a nice kick by Zach. And they're going to fair catch it again. Smart play there, I'd say.
Mm-hmm.
Zach Talbot with the kickoff for Loras. Fair caught.
I'll tell you what, this Duoc kickoff team. They're down there for purpose. They're going to get the ball back. That's what their purpose is. They will run through you. They'll whatever needs to be done, they're going to go get the ball.
I think the Eagles are going to have to try switching something up here. They haven't been able to score since the first quarter. Duoc have scored 21 unanswered points.
Yeah. I don't know what they're going to switch up, but
it's going to be hard because this defense is playing amazing right now.
Not much has been working for him.
Nope. Flanagan moving out of the pocket. Tries to throw to his receiver, Blake Mitchell, but defended well by Jack Foley.
There's a flag.
Oh. Middle of the field, what do you think that could be?
A pass interference or a hold on the defense.
But even...
Oh, lineman down the field.
That was just a great play by Jack Foley on the
defense, great play
right there too.
I was literally about to say or lineman down the field, but then I was like, nah, it's probably not.
You gotta trust yourself.
Yeah. I mean, how many times are they gonna try it? Flanagan's gonna keep throwing to whoever Foley's guarding, and it's just gonna be incompletion. Yeah. Or if he keeps trying, it's gonna be interception.
Yeah. Flanagan fakes the handoff, throws it at Jack Foley again. Oh, the receiver didn't see that ball on it.
That
one, on the side of the shoulder pads.
That one could have been a completion, but.
Yeah. Jamon Howard was the intended target there for the Eagles.
The receiver is number 83, Jamon Howard.
Second just wasn't ready for the ball.
Second and long here.
Caleb Seabit in motion. Flanagan, screen pass.
Ooh.
Lost it real high and almost turned over there. That was a dangerous pass. Flanagan looks a little shaken up down there on the field.
Yeah.
He's been getting hit almost every play so far.
Especially to keep running those screens. Yeah. He's going to keep getting lit up.
There's a lot of misdirection here in this Eagles offense, I've come to notice.
Yeah.
Always a guy in motion or a fake handoff or almost the run pass option. I feel like they've ran that a few times too.
Hasn't seemed to fool the Duoc defense.
No,
though.
It has not. That film work right there, you'd say?
Oh, yeah. Film work and staying true to your assignment.
Flanagan gets lit up again.
He caught it.
Oh, he caught it. Interception? Oh, ref saying to hit the ground.
Ooh, I think Mason Morris might have caught that one.
I honestly didn't know if he caught that or not. And then they're all saying they had the balls. Even
close.
Though it was incomplete, it's still a good job to come up with the ball.
Let's replay here, see if you can tell. Again, no time in the pocket.
Oh, Flanagan got lit up too there.
Oh, that never hit the ground.
That didn't hit the ground.
That was a pick.
That was an interception.
That was a pick.
K.J. Downey with the punt. Another high snap. Oh, he gets it away this time just before the Duck defenders get there. Ty gets it. Trying to surround by four Eagles defenders.
Yeah, nothing much there.
Nope.
Another good stiff arm there by him at the end.
Punt return by number 21, Ty Bosch. He's pushed out of bounds at the 45-yard line. First down for the Duhawks.
Duhawk offense, I imagine they're probably going to be run heavy this session. Probably not going to want to turn it over. Especially
going to get the ball at half.
Yeah.
Do you think it's going to be an equal mix between Sigworth, Bosch, and Eli, or what do you think is going to go
on? Probably a lot of reads, then Siggy, either him take it or one of the two running backs.
Duhawk's got four receivers out wide here with Ty and Sigworth in the backfield. Sigworth drops back to pass. Ooh, almost intercepted, but Sigworth was knocked down at the end of that play, too.
I think he's looking for a screen pass right there.
He had a few guys open.
Sigworth's pass
intended for Cook, but
up by number 41,
big
Gavin
D lineman
Bowser
got his hand on it. I believe he had Ty open, too, out of the backfield. Just not a whole lot of time for him.
Yeah, I think Bowser got his hand on it.
Yeah. Duhawks with a handoff here to Ty. Ty just working his way forward for a solid gain of 7 yards. Ty is really just the definition
rushing
of a workhorse out there for a running back.
Yeah.
Tackled at the 49-yard line. Third down.
Third and short here for Duhawks.
Sigworth gets the snap.
Oh.
Dropped by the receiver.
His other tight end, Mike
McDevitt. For number 13, Mike McDevitt.
Mike McDevitt, wide receiver last year. Probably would have been the number one this year, and they wanted him to move him. He's a big guy, big strong guy, so they figured he'd be pretty good in the box.
Yeah. Just hate to see the pass dropped. It would have been a first down, I believe, too.
Yeah.
Just past the sticks.
Yeah. Nothing hurt, though.
No.
Duhawk's still up.
Yeah. And they'll have a really good field flip here if they get a good punt here from Farfan. Oh, a good bounce.
Keep rolling.
Keeps rolling. Down to around the Eagles' 8-yard line.
Not a lot of airtime in that punt, but it sure did take a couple good
hits. Gets a nice spin on it.
Some good Duhawk bounces right there.
First down for Northwestern.
Maybe one of these times the Eagles aren't paying attention, they'll spin and hit one of them.
Yeah. Pick it up and score, huh?
Mm-hmm. If you're the Eagles, you just got to feel demoralized. You've been struggling to move the ball, then you get pinned in your own on your own side of the field. It's just hard for them.
You know, I'm not sure what the Eagles, what they should do, because nothing's really worked so far. This Duhawk defense plays with a purpose. They play with a swag, an attitude almost, you know.
Mm-hmm.
They're not going to let you move the ball.
No. Flanagan moving out of the pocket. Dumps it off to his man, who's met by two Duhawk defenders. That might be the most yards Eagles have got on a play in, since K.J. Downey took it all the way to the 10-yard line in the first quarter.
He's tackled at the 11-yard line.
Certainly up there.
Yeah.
Nothing clicking for this Eagle offense.
No. I think it's got to be a kudos to the front pressure that the Duhawks have been bringing all game.
Absolutely.
Flanagan gets the snap. Hands it off to his running back, who is tackled for no gain, I believe. Another third down here for the Eagles.
Rushing attempt by number 30, Jeremiah Statton. No gain on the play.
Just absolutely locked up. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. There's no other way to look at it.
I know some people don't like defense, but like, it's always fun to see a defense who can just swarm and stop the ball.
Yeah. Especially down low when it's the guys in the trenches.
Mm-hmm. It just got to be frustrating for an offense when you can't get past that front defensive line. Mm-hmm.
Can't run, can't pass. Mm-hmm.
Because Flanagan has been hit a lot this game. hasn't been able to sit in the pocket or do
anything.
It's
going to be a long bus ride home for Flanagan. Yeah, he's going to have a lot of bumps and bruises. Mm-hmm.
There's still a great crowd here, and there's even people sitting across the field in front of Rollman Residence Hall sitting and watching from that side, too.
Yeah, some away fans.
Yeah.
Gotta say, Hugh, the new Jumbotron, it's awesome.
It is. I enjoy it a lot.
It's nice when you walk by during the day and see good old Cabron Cook, number four, up there, or uh-huh. Sean Doyle. You'll see some football player up there. Yeah.
It's always nice to have a board where you can have replays, too, especially for a Division III school like us.
I believe it's in the top 10 for biggest in all of D3.
And it just looks beautiful, like you said, especially with the rock bowl across the top.
Yeah.
Flanagan gets a snap, throws it to Caleb Sini. Oh!
Almost intercepted.
Misses his man Caleb, overthrown. Brett Bauer almost with the interception there, but just falls out of his hands.
Right off the fingertips.
80, Caleb Sieben. It's fourth down for the Eagles.
And the graphics that have been going up on the board, too. I like those, too. They're nice.
See Big Sean Corgless with the chains.
Let's see if the Eagles can get a relatively good snap here. The last two on their punts have been high for KJ Downey. Oh, this snap is low. Ooh, a poor punt.
Straight up in the air.
Bounce to help the Eagles out a little bit.
This turf will give you bounces, that's for sure.
The last three snaps for KJ on the punts haven't been overly good. Two down. High snaps, and then that one was awfully low.
39-yard line. First and 10 for Loras.
Yeah. They can't get anything going on offense, and then the center seems to be shooting themselves even more in the foot with KJ Downing, I believe, is their punter.
Yeah.
Just making unbelievable catch after unbelievable catch. And also getting the ball off with Duhawks right in his face almost every snap.
It's always good to have a punter who's also an athlete.
Yeah.
Pistol formation here for Sigworth. He's got Ty in the backfield with him. Eli in motion. Ty gets the ball. Gain of around 3 yards there for him. Solid gain.
Rushing attempt by
another thing for the Duhawks. A lot of new cornerbacks this year. Last year, the only corner that's still here from last year to this year is Jack Foley.
Mm-hmm. And it's good to have that veteran leader, too.
Yeah.
Especially with how good he is as well.
Yeah, being one of your better players on the team.
Ty stopped in his place there around the first down marker.
Bosch with the carry once again.
This will be a third and three about. The Duhawks offense has really turned it on since that first quarter.
Yeah.
Maybe their coach got on a little bit or maybe something.
Yeah. I think everything turned once we got that fumble on the kickoff. Yeah.
Sigworth steps back from the shotgun, scrambles away from the defender. Throw on the run.
Oh.
Drop by, I believe, Ty.
Yeah.
That was a nice throw by Sigworth.
Sigworth's pass.
I mean, it was right on the money, too, especially from the run to being the defender.
It looked like the pressure up the middle had him, Siggy, dead to rights, but you just saw how good of an athlete he was, going 0 from 100, rolling out to the right, leaving him in the dust. That defender said no chance.
Yeah. Looks like the Duhawks will be going for it here. I guess you're in that no man's land from too long for a field goal, too short for a punt.
Especially less than 5 yards.
Mm-hmm. Sigworth gets it. Another design QB run here. I don't know if he got it.
I think he's short.
I think he is too.
Yeah, he's short.
Sigworth a little frustrated there.
Sigworth with the keeper.
Had one man to beat. Almost beat him too. Shoestring tackle.
The first down marker.
Good play.
It's a turnover on downs. The Eagles will take over.
Thank you. Flanagan alone there in the backfield in the shotgun. Five wide. Flanagan's snap, and he is obliterated as he throws it. And it's picked off by the Duhawks.
It's number five, Jace Gwynn. Let's go.
That was a nice pick there by Jace. And I think it almost has to do with that pressure once again. Everything's coming up around to the defense.
You know, last year and most of this year, Jace has been a wide receiver. They recently just moved him to corner, so it's great to see him making big plays after just switching positions.
And that was a good job there, as you saw, to keep his feet in bounds, too.
I think he's, at most, been playing corner for 2 months, at most.
Jeez, that pays off to have a cornerback used to play wide receiver.
Yeah, good hands.
Mm-hmm. And I think that ball's a little underthrown because
the pressure.
Flanagan got lit up as he threw it.
I believe it was McWilliams come run through there. I'll tell you, if there's anyone in this defense who's a heat-seeking missile, it's Brett McWilliams. He lives for the big hits.
Gotta love a guy who likes to have those big hits, too.
Mm-hmm.
Sigworth fakes the handoff to Eli, gets it to Cabron Cook. Cabron makes a guy miss, stumbles forward to around the Eagle 40-yard line.
We didn't have to say his name this time.
I know. It's been a while since we said his name, too.
Yeah, that's probably why.
We haven't been talking about him much.
That's on us. That's on us.
Duhawks look to keep it rolling here after the first down.
I believe McDevitt's lined up out wide.
Eli's get the ball. Makes the man cut. Got a hole. Nice run there by Eli to pick up another first down. Two plays in a row for the Duhawks for a first down.
That's another Loras College.
Tell you what, this Eagle seems starting to look a little bit defeated out there on the field.
Yeah, they are. As you can see here on the replay, Eli just makes cut after cut, makes guys miss, and then takes a few Eagle defenders to bring him down.
This Eagles defense has been doing their best trying to slow this Duhawk offense down. They've been doing a pretty good job, but they've just been out in the field so much because the Eagle offense cannot get anything going.
As Ty gets it, makes a man cut, flag is thrown. Ty just stays on his feet. Oh my gosh, that man is just like a man among boys, honestly.
Does he get another touchdown called back?
Yeah, that'd be
tough.
Heartbreaking.
Yeah, tough day at the office.
Mm-hmm. Especially with how much stuff, how many people he made miss and stay on his feet.
He's had some insane plays today.
As you can see here on the replay, the cut he makes bounces off his own blocker, stays on his feet.
Holding. But as you saw right there, the little change of speed, he has a little pitter-patter of his feet. He can stop on a dime and then go right back to 100.
I believe they called that on number 13, the tight end Mike McDevitt.
You can hear Jace Gwynn on the sideline saying, you can't throw that way. I don't think there's many ways you can throw on this Duhawk defense.
No, I don't think there is either. Got to love a little bit of trash talking, too.
Mm-hmm.
Eli Thomas checked back in. He's being motioned out wide. Sigworth alone in the backfield. Throwing it, has a man wide open. Nice catch there for the Duhawks. Number 86, Marty McGovern.
Marty McGovern.
That's good enough for a Loras.
As you can see on this replay, Sigworth had a nice pocket for him to evaluate and go over all his looks, and then he just hit his man wide open.
Zone there for found a soft spot in the zone.
Mm-hmm. Eli with the ball tackled around the 2 yard line, maybe even the 1 yard line.
Carry by number 16, Elijah Thomas, tackled at the one-yard line.
Going hurry up.
Hurrying it up. Thinking Sigworth might sneak it here in the hurry up?
Yeah. Oh.
Did he get it? I think he got it. Yep. Yeah. Sigworth with another touchdown, his second rushing touchdown of the game.
Touchdown,
the rushing attack from this team. All three spots. Eli, Ty, Siggy. It's tough to stop.
Yeah.
So many guys you have to worry about.
Mm-hmm. You can see on the replay here, that initial spot for the seek wasn't open, so he just moved over to the open side, and a good job by him to having the mind to reach for the end zone and get the touchdown.
Yeah, great smart play by the Duhawks leader right there.
Farfan's extra point is up. Good once again.
Automatic.
Extra point is good by number 33, Nick Farfan.
Again, the most dangerous man on the field, touchback Talbot.
I know. I mean, think about it. Kickers win and lose you a whole lot of games.
Yeah.
And that is 28 unanswered points there for the Duhawks. Boys, the Duhawks play like this all season. They're going to be a fun team to watch.
Yeah, it's going to be a great season here for the Duhawks. Mm-hmm.
Zach getting his steps ready to take this kick and hopefully get a touchback here. Zach, nice little line drive kick. You're going to fair catch it. Ooh, good thing he fair caught that. That might have bounced out of bounds.
Yeah. I think that definitely is going out of bounds.
Fair catch by number 23, Keegan James.
That was a little bit more of a line drive kick than what he's had before.
Absolutely, kind of a corkscrew right there.
Mm-hmm.
No, he usually I'm a pretty positive guy, always looking for the most positive outcomes, trying to keep positive. If I'm the offense coordinator here for the Eagles, I don't know what else to do. Honestly, yeah. Everything you try, the Duhawks been all over. The one screen pass worked, but every time they tried it since, has not.
Yeah. They hand off to the running back, James, and like we said, nothing's been working. He's met behind the line again.
Marcus Lampley.
There's just absolutely nothing these guys can do.
Nothing.
Brought down for a loss.
This defense is just
Marcus Lampley.
It's honestly hard to describe. That's how good they're playing right now.
Down,
like, we saw that motion right there. We're talking about this team's law of motion. Duhawks staying disciplined, knowing their role, knowing who their man is, sticking to it.
And a lot of times the stuff with, like, motion is a lot of guys don't stick to their places or whatever, and then that beats a team. The passer. Oh, good breakup there by, was that Jack Foley?
Yep.
I believe it was. The intended target there for Flanagan was Blake Mitchell, who's also their kicker.
Third down at the 20-yard line.
Wow, a lot of dual threats. Yeah.
Yeah.
Once again, one thing I might tell Flanagan, though, is don't throw it to Foley's side.
Yeah. Or Jace's side either, by the way. Yeah. He's talking. Flanagan fakes the handoff, and it's a screen pass again, and Duhawks are all over that one. Number 44, Josh Jones for the Duhawks, read that extremely well and met the running back James there in the backfield and broke it up.
Josh Jones.
I don't know if there is a single weakness on this Duhawk defense.
I don't know if there is. See, as you can see here on the replay, you can just see Josh coming in, breaking up the pass. Just a great read by your linebacker. Really like to see them making those plays.
Mm-hmm. And once again, Flanagan getting lit up at the end of the play.
He's going to have a lot of ice on him on the bus ride back.
I bet Clapper's watching this on the sideline being like, boy, I'm glad this on me.
Oh! High snap for the Eagles, and they're just going to take the safety on that one. Like we've been talking about, the snaps on these punts have been hurting the Eagles a whole bunch.
A bad snap by the Eagles results in a safety.
There's no flag. Safety.
Wow. We were waiting on it.
I know, yeah. And we didn't even see it. We were talking, and I just saw the ball go flying. Defense coordinator Bauer there's – you got to think he's got to be happy with his defensive performance.
He's got to love the defensive performance so far.
Mm-hmm. Now the offense can really just extend this one here.
30 unanswered points.
Mm-hmm. Got to love it.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see here on the camera, the new – coach there for the Duhawks.
Coach Jones.
Yeah. I believe he came up from Louisiana.
Yeah.
I believe he was a high school coach, and then he came in here and took this special team job.
He's coached all over. He's coached at every level. He's actually done a little bit in the NFL, too, scouting.
Good to have that presence on your team.
Yeah.
A guy who's been around and knows a few things.
He's coached some Louisiana greats, I believe. Man, I'm trying to think. Joey told me. At least two guys in the NFL. And he's really, you know, Patrick Surtain, top cornerback, draft prospect. Mm-hmm. Apparently, really good friends with his dad.
Oh.
Also, apparently, good friends with Lil Wayne's brother and Lil Wayne.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Good to have those connections.
Yeah.
KJ with the punt here after the safety. Ty gets it. He's got a hole. Oh, he got. Oh, good block there. That was a good block there by the Duhawks to flatten the guy to give Ty a hole, and he almost took that one to the house. He just deserves the touchdown after the way he's been playing and getting those two call back on him.
Come on, give him one.
Returned by number 21, Ty Bausch, tackled at the 41-yard line.
First this Duhawk team just seems to want it more in every facet so far.
As you can see here, there's great blocks there for Ty. The pancake right there, right before Ty got knocked out of bounds, that's just great blocking. Gotta love to see the pancakes.
Always tough watching the film when you're the guy that gets pancaked.
Sigworth keeps it and brought down after a gain of around 5 yards. Oh, that wasn't Sigworth.
I think that was Eric Raddick.
Oh, okay. I believe that's his first touch of the game, too.
Yeah, I think so. Gone in motion. Yeah, it's Eric Raddick. Gone in motion a couple times. Senior running back. Another guy who's insane numbers in the weight room.
Mm-hmm. He gets the ball again here. A solid gain of about 6 yards there. Awfully close to a first down here.
Rushing attempt by number 32, Eric Raddick. Tackled at the
third and four here for
line.
The Duhawks with a minute 55 to go in the half.
Ty and Eli kind of being that combo type of running back, kind of being able to do it all. Raddick's more of the power, like I'm going to run it straight through you type of running back.
Always good to have a guy who's you just expect to run a person over.
Yeah, you got
to
have the yin and yang.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Sigworth has a hole, making guys miss. Ty throws a block.
Sigworth, what a play!
Oh, out of bounds on I believe, the Eagles' 5-yard line. Sigworth was making plays right there. And let's take another look at that one, folks. Sigworth, the pocket collapsed on him, so he uses legs and just runs away from everybody. Makes the guys miss. And then Ty had a huge block right there.
Yeah, stood that guy right up.
And then a good hurdle by Sigworth. Oh, wish he didn't step out of bounds. That would have been a highlight play right there.
It's beautiful football right there. Raddick.
Raddick gets it. Running in.
Down
on the 1 yard line. Honestly, give it to Raddick again.
Number 32.
He's been working hard this drive.
Tackled at the 1 yard line, second and goal.
Pistol formation with Raddick in the backfield. They hand it off to him, and he gets it in for the touchdown.
Eric Raddick with the carry. Touchdown, Duhawks.
Duhawks now with 36 unanswered points.
What
on the replay
drive.
Here, he just had a whole bunch of space. Good blocking up front there by the linemen and tight ends and everybody.
Got in untouched.
Mm-hmm.
Automatic.
Farfan.
Extra point is
Nick
good.
Automatic. Farfan. I think some fans starting to leave.
Yeah. They're going to miss out on a great second half.
Yeah. Don't give up on the boys.
Yeah.
Come on.
Maybe they're getting too cold.
Yeah.
As the sun's getting down, it's getting a bit chilly out here.
They're probably just going to the cars, get the jackets, sit there at
halftime,
come back.
Yeah. Makes sense. Yeah. Understandable. I do that sometimes.
Probably,
they're
probably going to go listen to our halftime.
Yeah.
Show.
Can't blame them.
Yeah.
We're so good.
I think the youngness of this Eagle team's really shown so far.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A lot of their first games, probably a lot of freshmen, a lot of sophomore. Only 7 seniors, so.
Yeah. Kind of crazy to think about. They're a small team, too, compared to the Duhawks.
Yeah, out there in warm-ups, you can just tell the differences in the rosters. They have guys from all over, though. I was looking at all the hometowns, yeah, California, it, Colorado.
I know. That's kind of crazy coming all the way up from California and coming to Minnesota. That's got to be a shock in the winter.
Yeah, that's a big change.
Yeah.
Big change.
Zach kicking it off again here.
Touchback Talbot.
Better kick than the last one. They're fair catching it again. I don't know if they're probably going to be done returning it for the rest of this game, I'd say.
I think he's probably no need to take an unnecessary hit.
Talbot
with the kickoff. A fair catch by Keegan James. First down for the Eagles at the 25.
Think the Eagles are going to be able to get anything going here?
I don't know. It's going to be hard. But maybe with a minute 04 left, they'll stop thinking it over so much, go with the hurry-up offense. Maybe then they'll get something to click.
Yeah.
Maybe get these our Duoc defense caught a little off guard on our heels. Maybe tire them out a little bit. Seben in motion. Flanagan keeps it on the run-pass option. Almost intercepted. Oh, a flag thrown. Nice catch there by... the Duhawk defensive back.
I think that was Zacchaeus Knight.
Pass is incomplete, intended for KJ Downey. There's a penalty marker down on the field.
I think Zach Kemp might have gotten his fingertips on the ball right there.
Well, I don't know if.
There's no flag because we have to fall.
Yeah.
I was going to say.
Yeah. There's a little contact there, but after it got tipped, it's no call.
That was great defense again by the Duhawks once again.
Mm-hmm. Great catch also by Zach. Catch the flag.
Yeah, catch right that back. Flag. That's pretty smooth.
I'll tell you what. One thing I learned about Zach, he's smooth in everything he does.
Flanagan hands it off to his running back, who is just stopped once again behind the line.
I believe they tried pulling someone right there, and the linebacker just filled the gap.
I believe that Josh Jones again, I believe?
What? I'm pretty sure, and I would not be surprised if it was.
Just around the ball a lot so far.
Yeah. Another third and long, just like that.
Loss by number 44, Josh Jones. Third down.
The Eagles probably going to try to kill the clock, just let it run to halftime, then let the Duhawks get the ball back.
I think they're going to have to run one more play, maybe.
Yeah. Run one more.
There's a 13-second difference between the play clock and the game clock. Flanagan hands it off to James, and James gets... back to around the original line of scrimmage here, and I gotta think that'll take us to halftime.
Yeah, unless the Ducks are gonna call timeout. They're not.
So at halftime, your Duhawks 37, the Eagles 6. Duhawks with 37 unanswered points there. And now we're gonna toss it. And now we're going to toss it down to our sideline reporter, Adam Rodriguez.
Thanks, guys. The Duhawks started off real slow but found the groove really quickly after a nice touchdown from Noah Sigworth to Hunter Machi. The Loras defense got the momentum on our side after a huge fumble recovery by Dawson Charlie, leading to a Duhawk touchdown. That's all I got for you. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Adam. And, you know, Hugh, we're talking about this Duhawk defense, how well they've been playing. We saw Jace Gwynn make that great interception. We saw Jack Foley lock up every single throw that's run to him. And speaking to the Foley brothers, I think we ran a little special about them not too long ago on Sports Zone. So I think we're going to turn it to that now.
Me and him work out on Mondays, and every once in a while we'll be in the same group and stuff.
Yeah, obviously Coach Edwards kind of decides the workout schedule based off our class schedule and our extracurriculars with practice. So I think we're in the weight room about two or three times a week right now. But I mean, I think that's a cool part about being on the football team here is that you're working out with a different group every day because there's so many of us. So
usually back home with everything that happened with quarantine, we were able to have a family friend make us a squat rack. So we put that to use a lot. We'd kind of wake up, do our Zoom classes and whatnot, and then me and Joey would go out there and do our workouts that Coach Edwards and the strength team would send. So it was pretty convenient being able to have somebody to work out with. a lot of guys didn't have that opportunity when they went home, so it's nice.
In high school, we were never on the same team, obviously, because we had 2 years difference, so it was like a little different from me. He was kind of like the senior captain, you know, I was always watching him, looking up to him and stuff. And then that was kind of a big decision when I went to Loras, is being able to play with him. So then last year, we finally got to take the field together, and that was a lot of fun. We kind of feel that chemistry, I guess. Just being able to look over the other side at corner and seeing him, it was really cool. So it's pretty nice having you on the field as you. So.
That was just a great piece there about the Foley brothers and just see what it takes to be a good player for the Duhawks, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then we'll be taking a quick break here in the second half, and we'll pick back up with you guys. Welcome back here to the Rock Bowl, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to just touch down quick about how a little bit of a recap of the first half. The Eagles' lone touchdown came in from a pass from Ryan Flanagan into the corner of the end zone, which was a fairly nice pass that he made and a good catch by his receiver.
Yeah, perfect pass where only the receiver could catch. Nice toe drag at the corner of the end zone.
It was, yeah. And then Sigworth has 4 total touchdowns, 2 passing and 2 rushing. And the passing touchdowns, they're thrown on a dime, really. Yeah,
one to Machi on a nice post route, and then one to Cabron, a nice comeback.
And then his rushing touchdowns were pretty good, too. The sneak in, and then it was a fairly lengthy run for his other rushing touchdown.
Yeah, weaving through the defense.
Yeah. And then Raddick had the other touchdown, rushing touchdown for the Duhawks.
Yeah, always good to see the senior scoring touchdown. Mm-hmm. And then in other Duhawk events today, the Rock Bowl hosting a plethora of events today. First off, women's soccer, huge dub. Shout out Olivia DeVries. Then men's soccer followed another dub. Then men's volleyball also played here against Augustana for the first ever program win against Augustana.
Oh,
so that's huge.
Shout out to the men's volleyball team.
And two big standouts for track and field. Carly Fisher takes first in the discus. And Cassie Rosenbaum wins with yet another school record, winning the 3,000 meter.
That's impressive.
She's racking up school records.
Could be one of the greatest distance runners to come through this program.
Might be the GOAT.
Maybe, yeah.
It might be the GOAT.
Second half about to go underway here, and it has gotten very dark here in the Rock Bowl.
Yeah, very quickly.
Mm-hmm. But nothing like a little Saturday night lights.
Yes, sir. Playing under the lights. So at halftime, if you're Loras, I'm thinking coaches are saying, keep it up. Don't let off with the brakes. Mm-hmm.
Just the Eagles really keep the chokehold on them, really.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Defense, keep it up. Offense, let's step it up. Maybe one more gear.
Yeah.
Maybe one more gear. If you're the Eagles, don't think you can be happy.
Points.
Yeah, don't think you can be. Defense hasn't played too bad. I wouldn't say they play great or good, but I'd say they play all right. And then the offense is playing not too good.
Oh, nice little squib kick right there to start off the half and nails the Duhawk in the chest, but he keeps it. It was a pretty good play there.
Yeah, I think they try to catch the front line slipping when they're turned to go block. But the Duhawks are on top of it.
And like you said about the Eagle defense, it's not that they haven't been playing poorly. They've just been out on the field a lot so far this game. They're just getting tired. And then that's where Eli and Ty come into play and the duo they have. And it just really hurts the defense. Tires them out even more than what they probably already are.
Yeah, you can see in some of these plays just how tired these Eagle defenders are, not being able to follow the ball carrier.
Think Loras is gonna take a shot here or hand it off to Eli?
No, they're gonna hand it off probably. Up big.
Well, I mean, he handed it off to Eli. It's almost like taking a shot in its own way. Just one of the players who every time he touches it, you think he can take it to the end zone.
Oh, absolutely.
And he does hold that freshman year. He broke the single game kick return record and the season kick return record as well.
Wow. Eli Thomas.
Super fast.
Fastest kid this side of Mississippi.
Oh, little switchery.
Oh, he's wide open. Oh, McDevitt. What a play. That was sick. Let's go.
What a beautiful play there by Sigworth and then Loras. That's all the trickery. Oh, my
Let's
goodness.
Go.
Goosebumps right there.
Let's go.
I just got goosebumps. Oh, my God. That was amazing.
Let's go.
Sigworth's fifth touchdown of the game, third passing touchdown.
They said, you take it. No, you take it. No, you take it. Touchdown.
Eagles were looking silly out there. They're all confused. What was there, three passes there before the touchdown pass?
Yeah, McDevitt's wide open down the field.
I'm sure in his head he's thinking, just don't drop it.
Yeah, or trip.
Automatic again for the extra point.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I can't get over that play, though. Got the blood pumping to start this half.
Wow.
I figured they'd probably try something a little different out here with the lead.
Yeah. Did you talk to offensive coordinator at halftime here? I don't know.
Maybe a little insider information. I don't know. I can't give away my sources. And maybe coming out of halftime, too, Eagle defense being a nice little warm locker room, maybe a little tight coming out here back into the colder weather.
Yeah, maybe. The one thing, you said this last half, maybe just try to change the pace. Mm-hmm. They haven't gone fast at all. Yeah. Even when they had a minute left, they were taking their time.
Yeah.
Change the pace. Try to see if the Duoc defense responds.
Mm-hmm. Maybe the Eagle new offensive coordinator hasn't thought about like switching the pace up yet. First game as offensive coordinator, I'm sure it's just like a freshman playing in, a little nervous about making the plays and all that stuff, but he's got to try something different.
Especially with a younger team, it might be a little harder, but hey.
Give him some more experience, maybe.
Touchback Talbot.
Oh, no fair catch this time. Oh, breaks a tackle. Flag on the back. I honestly thought he might have lost it there when that first guy missed the tackle.
Keegan James with the return. There is a penalty marker down on the field.
They can't get anything to go their way.
And he returned that to around the 25-yard line.
Yeah.
And moving them back now. They've really just been hurting themselves this whole game with all these penalties. And there has been a lot of penalties called today so far.
It's like half a step forward, 17 steps back for this Eagles team.
And especially with how this Duhawk defense is playing, you do that to yourself and you're not gonna be able to move the ball.
Not gonna have a chance.
No. I wonder if he's gonna try and throw it at Jack Foley again this half.
He better hope not.
Or don't throw it at Jace either. Yeah. Jace will pick him off. Ooh. Flanagan's first throw of the half. Misses wide receiver a little wide. Let him a little too far there.
He had him too.
Yeah.
Screen passes have seemed to be the only thing really they can get going. They have motion. They've handed the ball off.
And then wide open and you miss that opportunity.
Yeah, it's a killer.
Yeah, it is. Got to feel there's going to be a lot of passes here now for the Eagles down by so much.
I have to think the Deluxe might stop passing the ball here soon, maybe this on third downs.
Yeah. Eagles put a man in motion. They hand it off to the running back, James, who was met behind the line for about a loss of one or no gain.
No, earlier we were talking about the losses on the D-line. Mm-hmm. Bryson, all-conference. Tyler Poggenpohl, all-conference. Two great defensive linemen, interior. And we've seen it so far. Marcus Lampley and the Wellborns, they've stepped up. Eli Dirtz, a freshman, they've stepped up today, making plays in the backfield almost every play, getting the quarterback's face. So that's huge.
Yeah.
That's huge.
Shout out to the recruiting, too, to be able to have those guys come in and play. The freshmen, good job to those guys, to the recruiters, and being able to develop the players as well.
Mm-hmm.
Flanagan moved, pushed out of the pocket. Oh, nice pass and tough catch there by his receiver, but it'll still be fourth down. He did not reach the marker. Once again on a Flanagan pass, yes, he gets pushed out of the pocket again, but that was probably maybe the best throw and catch they've had.
Just ran in on defense.
It's fourth down.
Oh, they're punting. That's why. Oh,
who?
Never mind.
Okay.
All right. I was going to say, I was like, why? I was so confused. I was like, McDevitt's playing D-line? This is sick.
Let's see if the snap. Better than the previous snaps.
Liner.
Ty telling everybody to get away from it. Goes out of bounds around the 43-yard line there. The rolling Duhawk offense will be coming back out there. They're just on this cold night, they're heating it up at the Rock Bowl.
That is true. This purple is looking pretty good.
It is.
Under lights.
The helmet's got the lights shining off of them.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, purple, I mean, I just... It's also just a nice purple color, too. Especially with the gold lettering.
Mm-hmm.
Just looks nice.
Beautiful uniforms.
Yeah, they are. Sigworth in the backfield with Thomas.
Oh,
fakes the handoff. Passes it to...
Cabron.
Cabron Cook. Solid gain there. Gets the first down.
That's like a 20-yard gain.
That was a nice pass.
To number four, Cabron Cook. Result of the play is the Loras College. First down.
As you can see here on the Duhawks faked the run. Got the Eagles off guard and then threw it to Cabron for a nice pass. Another fake run pass. Gets it off to his receiver. Makes a man miss.
Fine.
And then knocked out of bounds. Whoa. A little extracurricular activity there.
Yeah.
Duhawks
sideline didn't like that.
Good job to not do anything after it, though. You're up by a whole lot. Don't want to maybe miss it the next game or something for doing something out of anger.
He got an earful out of it.
Yeah. I think the Eagles might start getting a little chippy here down by a bundle. Another pass here. Gets it to Eli. Eli has a bunch of space. He's got blockers.
Oh, great blocker.
Cuts in. Taken down on the Eagle 15. He just has great vision for a ball carrier, and then he has the speed and ability to make the cuts to go with it, too.
Most dangerous man on the field.
Mm-hmm. Like I said earlier, whenever he touches it, he has the potential to take it to the end zone.
Big play potential.
Mm-hmm. Almost like a Tyreek Hill.
Yeah. His running back for him.
Yeah. Eli gets the handoff, makes a cut. And he's tackled on the 4-yard line, it looks like.
Rushing attempt, number 16, Elijah Thomas. That's another Loras College first down. First and goal.
Early in the game, we were talking about Duhawks last season going 5-5, better than they have been, but still not where they want to be.
Yeah.
This season, I think they might go 5-0.
A nice little jet sweep here. Gets in for the end zone for a touchdown.
Let's go.
Javon Williams, the freshman.
First career touchdown. Let him keep the football.
Yeah, give him the football. Yeah. Come on. I mean, and he's had a great game for a freshman as well.
Oh, absolutely. Ton of targets.
Mm-hmm.
Jet sweep, too.
He's going to be fun to watch these next four years.
Yeah.
It's going to be fun to watch him grow as a player and maybe become one of the best players to play for the Duhawks.
Hopefully.
Mm-hmm. Right down the middle. I don't even got to say it anymore.
I close my eyes, be like, it's right down the middle every time. We're talking about Duhawks last year. We're saying, they're 5-5. Not where they want to be, but better than they have been. This year, I think it's 5-0, 4-1 potential. Wartburg, that's going to be tough. Wartburg's always good. But UD, this is the year the UD streak ends. Loras, I'm calling it right now. Loras is going to beat UD.
I like the confidence.
I feel it.
And rivalry game, the intensity is going to be there.
Closest rivalry in college football, 8 blocks.
I know. Delicious. I'm going to be excited for that game.
Yeah, this is going to be packed.
Mm-hmm.
Packed. And the last couple of years has been like one play that's gone wrong for Duhawks against UD. They've been right in it or winning most of the time. This one play kind of ruins it. But, this year, it's not going to happen.
Nope.
This touchback Talbot gets ready.
Looks like number 17, Trevor
Suizao.
Suizao is getting warmed up there on the sideline. Maybe showing the end of the day for Sigworth.
Yeah.
With this big lead. Don't want to risk getting your.
Oh, yeah. Siggy's throwing on the penny.
Yeah, I love to see the backup get some playing time here. A junior, too, so maybe after Siggy graduates, we'll see what next year will look like.
Yeah. Another great coverage on the kickoff there by the Duhawks.
I got to think they're almost returning now, hoping to break something here instead of just fair catching it.
Yeah. Tell you what, Suizao lives right next to me. Nelmec, great guy.
Yeah.
Great guy.
Returned by Keegan James.
So it's easy to root for then.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes he's walking his girlfriend's dog. Very cute dog, too. Yeah.
I'm a huge dog guy. Oh, I love dogs.
Dogs are the best.
I know. I wonder if the Eagles might throw in their backup too, because Flanagan has been taking a beating
back
there today.
Yeah, I don't want him to get hurt.
Flanagan steps back to the middle of the field.
There's something.
Yeah. Is that a first down?
Close.
Be their first down since their touchdown, probably.
I think it honestly is their first touchdown.
Oh, they got the first down, too.
Since the first since the first quarter, wow.
Yeah. Just good job there by Duhok defense. Flanagan and James in the backfield, shotgun formation. Duhoks have a few players in the box. Oh, a little reverse. Trickery. I believe that's Jamon Howard with it. Trickery didn't really do him much good.
I was like, all right, this is something here.
I thought they were going to break something free, and then Duhoks just swarmed to the ball again. To the 34.
Staying to their assignment.
Mm-hmm.
That's big.
Good job to the coaches to preach that on their players, mm-hmm. and they actually follow through with it. Mm-hmm. Flanagan gets the drop back.
Oh!
Almost intercepted by
Josh Jones.
Josh Jones. We've been saying his name a lot today, too.
Yeah.
Always around the ball.
Flanagan's pass is incomplete, broken up by number 44, Josh Jones.
Pride of Wilmington, Illinois.
Mm-hmm.
See Jack Foley getting the break here, letting the younger guys get some more run.
Good to get those guys a little bit of experience here in these games. Eagles send a man in motion, fake the run. Flanagan, he's got his man open. And he drops the pass. That was KJ Downey who dropped the pass.
Flanagan's pass is incomplete.
Pass was a little high, but for the most part, he put it where only his guy could get it.
Probably should have caught.
Yeah. Downey was kind of covered there by a DB.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I wasn't able to see which DB it was.
It was Jace.
It was.
Yeah.
Don't throw his way.
Yeah, don't throw. He told us.
I know.
He did tell us.
They weren't listening.
No. I think the problem was is he was facing us when he said it, so they couldn't hear him.
Didn't hear him, yeah.
You think they might run a fake?
Touchback here for the... And then we're going to toss it down here to Adam Rodriguez down here on the sideline.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, Duhoks came back after the break real hot as quarterback Noah Sigworth threw a beautiful touchdown pass to Mike McDivitt off of a very nice flea flicker. Duhoks on the Duhoks' very first possession of the half. Back to you guys.
Thanks for that great report, Adam. And that was a better snap there for the long snapper there for the Eagles.
Yeah, it was. I was about to say, you think they might run a fake punt once with all the times they've punted something and go for it on fourth down.
And going off of what Adam said about the flea flicker, I mean, still,
that was
such a good
play.
I'm still like amazed by it, honestly.
Yeah.
New quarterback in the game for the Duhoks as Ty gets the ball, pushes forward for a solid 9 yards. Think they're going to air the ball out here with Trevor in the game, or think they're going to
I'd say on third down.
Third down?
On third and long, probably. If it's third and short, I'd still think they might run it.
Yeah. Is he a mobile quarterback? More mobile?
Not as much as Siggy, but he's more a traditional pocket passer, but he is surprising. He's sneaky athletic for sure.
As Ty picks up the first down there, giving Duhawks another first down.
Tackled at the 32.
The Eagles just, they just look tired out there.
Yeah.
Our notes are getting blown away by the wind here.
Strong gusts of wind coming in. Getting more of a bit of chilly night here.
Yeah, it is. Ty gets the ball again. He's got holes. Oh, runs into his own lineman. Lineman kind of got pushed forward there. Just showing the strength of Ty.
Ty's a wrecking ball, man.
Ball in a china shop.
Yeah. How does he see Ty talking to Coach H down there about running into the lineman?
I think Eli's day might be done. He's got his helmet off and his hands just talking it up out there.
Yeah, I can't imagine he's going to get too many more carries.
I believe that was Raddick who just got the ball there.
Yeah.
Carry for a solid game. Eric Raddick. Tackled at the 42-yard line. That's another Loras College first down.
Another Duhawk first down here as Raddick's in the backfield. Ty out wide. Little screen pass here. Nice lead there by Trevor to Ty. That was a solid lead pass on the screen there, I think.
Yeah.
Pass is complete by number 17.
Good pass,
Westiesel. Mm-hmm. The receiver was number 21, Ty Bausch. Ball is spotted at the 46.
I keep my eyes on number 9, Harrison Willis, this drive.
Ooh, number 15 came in there untouched.
he tackled Sweez out on the handoff.
Yeah. Oh!
Dulock's
Raddick just kept pushing forward there.
Carrying the pile.
Yeah.
Result of the play is another Loras College first down. See the replay.
As you can see here, what we were talking about was number 15 just came in untouched there, but luckily we got the handoff off in time.
Raddick gets another one.
Ooh, tackle. Raddick met at the line there. Got to think the Eagles will be starting to pack the box here.
Oh, yeah.
With Duhawk big lead and not willing to throw the ball probably.
Yeah, make him throw it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, number 9 is going to make a big play at some point in this game.
Okay.
Harrison Willis.
Tie on the screen pass. Oh, makes a couple guys miss. Nice play there by Ty. Big guys miss.
That's a great move by Ty and a great block by McGovern.
Yeah.
Pass is
Ty comes out. He's looking a little tired out there.
Line. Yeah.
Third down.
You can see the screen pass here as Ty just good block there and he just makes a man miss. Fake the read option and Raddick gains a solid amount of yards there, making it fourth down and 2.
I think they're going to go for it. It's a little bit out of our fans' range.
Yeah.
Rushing attempt by number 32, Eric Raddick.
This looks like a pretty big blitz coming here. Oh, got him.
Oh, got him.
Oh,
they didn't hike it.
Didn't snap it.
Yep. Telling you. Hit 9 on this.
On the slant?
Yeah.
Drag route, maybe?
Yeah.
This looks like a big blitz coming in here.
Oh.
I was wrong.
Oh,
he's
going
it out.
Oh.
That would have been a nice catch there.
Yeah.
Might have been put on You Got Moss there if you would have came down with it.
Yeah. Even though they didn't get it, I think that's worth it just because they would have been so cool.
Yeah.
For number 80, Corey Linder.
Corey Linder. Intended target there.
That's a turnover on
good
down.
To see the sender, or the sender, the senior getting over. Some reps.
Yeah. Got to start thinking we'll see a few of the backup guys coming in here on defense too.
Looks like got some new.
Looks like Flanagan's still in there at quarterback, and he's joined by Statton in the backfield. Fakes the run, roll out on the bootleg. Has his man.
Wow.
Completed.
Nice
catch.
Yeah.
That was pretty good defense there by the Duhawks.
Number 18, Antonio Alvarado, the freshman, is in that corner.
Tackle at the 45-yard line. Result of the play is a first down.
We got Jacob Aquendo and Patrick Suddy in at safety. Tell you what, one guy this football team loves, Jacob Aquendo. Great guy.
Is he that glue in the locker
room?
Oh,
he's
everybody
that,
heart
he
that
is
stuff?
The glue guy in the locker room, I'd say.
Always good to have one of those. That guy moved. Oh, I think he's shifting. Okay, I was going to say, I thought I saw somebody move.
Yeah.
I didn't know if it was a tight end or not. It's a big left tackle. Got called there for the false start, I believe.
You know, earlier we were talking about new cornerback coach, Loras Scott. They also have a new defensive line coach who've heard really good things about.
He's paying off because the defensive line has been
yeah.
playing really well so far today.
Yeah. Oh,
Flanagan on the keeper.
Ooh. Did not get down quick
no,
enough.
No, he did not. met by a swarm of Duhawks.
He's trying to do his best Sigworth impression right there.
Should have slid.
Yeah.
Ryan playing again with the rushing attempt.
It's almost like he tried to slide and drop down.
He just, 3 yard line. His body is almost as if his body just gave up. He's like, I'm going down.
All those hits he's taking, I thought he might have wanted to go down a little earlier. He gets it to Downey. Downey met about 3 yards past the line of scrimmage and tackled. I believe that was by Antonio again.
That's Charlie Dawson.
Complete to number 4, KJ Downey. He's tackled at the 49-yard line. Third down.
I almost have to think here that the Eagles just might go for it on this fourth down.
If
they don't convert on a third down here.
As long as they don't get like sacked or something.
Yeah. Oh, man, they just got sacked.
My bad. Yep, here comes the punt team.
Yeah.
I think there might have been Dirtz in the backfield, the freshman.
Flanagan is sacked by number 97, yeah. Elijah Dirtz.
The big man.
Yeah.
You know, one of the big reasons he came here is this big powerlifting guy, and we have one of the best strength and conditioning coaches in all of D3, maybe all of college sports, and Josh Edwards, great coach.
Always good to have that guy in there to get you guys bigger in the weight room and all that.
Ooh,
punt almost blocked. Tie on the return. Fakes it like he's going to pick it up, but he doesn't. Dang. A little mad at himself.
He's probably a little too close for that one to not catch. He almost hit him on the back bounce, so not. Coaches would not have been happy.
No, they would not have.
Punt by the Eagles is down at the 10-yard line.
So with this being the first game in our spring 2021 season, what are your predictions for the outcome of the rest of the Steelhawks season? I know we've talked about it a little bit, but, like, can I go more?
I think I'm going to say it, 5-0.
Okay.
5-0. We're going to beat Warburg. We're going to beat UD. I'm confident in this team.
Okay.
I'm confident.
I like the confidence.
We got returners in a lot of spots. Mm-hmm. Got some new guys in some spots, but a
lot of talent on this team.
Yeah, a lot of talent from freshmen all the way to senior. Mm-hmm. There's, I mean, we've seen it from like Javon.
Yeah,
he's shifty. He's fast. He catches the ball. He's getting the ball a lot. Got Colton Bauer carrying the rock now.
Just bouncing off of guys.
Mm-hmm.
Rushing attempt by number 34, Colton Bauer. Tackled at the 13-yard line.
What do you think, Hugh? What do you think about this Duhawk season?
You know, Warburg, they're always tough, you know? So I could see 4-1.
Mm-hmm.
5-0,
it's tough.
I'll hope for it. Mm-hmm. I mean, it might be a little tough because Warburg's just always so good, but I could see a strong chance of a 5-0 season, like you. Because just like you said, all the talent that this team has, and I just, you know, I have a lot of faith in these guys. As an Eagle player, is a little slow to get up there on the field.
I know the past couple of years, last year the defense took on a lot. They played really great, and sometimes the offense came up short. And I think the year before, it kind of seemed to be the other way around. The offense would always, it would always be high-scoring games, and the defense just couldn't get a stop. Oof. Lucky to not be intercepted.
Yeah.
Not a great throw there by Suizo.
No. First and 10 here for the Duhawks. That screech of the Eagle, that's
it's a great fact.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, great catch there by Linder after the bobble.
Oh, got some space. Good sportsmanship there by the Eagles, number 24, to help up Linder there.
He's pushed out of bounds at the 40,
I think technically it was a Duhawk screech. I know they're I think Duhawks and Eagles, I think they might be cousins, so they have similar screeches.
I was somewhere in the family tree.
I think it's just like a little bit like the Duhawks might have a little bit of deeper pitch, you know?
Yeah. Makes sense, yeah.
No gain right there.
Rushing attempt by number 34, Colton Bauer. A loss of one on the play. Second down.
I think they might have to get number 9 Harrison Willis the ball.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
Let him work.
I'm telling you, if you let H eat, H is going to capitalize.
Yeah.
Give to him.
Oh, the pass. Ooh. Nice great. Little pass and catch there.
Yeah. Great snag there by McGovern.
Trevor held on to that ball till he absolutely had to let go of it, too.
He's pushed out of bounds at the 50. Third down.
Trevor motions his running back out, all alone there in the backfield. Steps back.
Get it to him. Yeah, let's go, H.
Oh.
Let's go, H. Let's go.
Gets it to Harrison Willis there for a first down and a big gain.
Niner. Let Jesus nine eat.
Harrison Willis.
Harrison just.
Result of the play is a Loras. I told you.
EJ's been hyping
him up. He's going to make a play.
I mean, EJ did not lie to us.
Let's go.
EJ Greenberg, the most trusted color commentator in sports.
I think they might have to feed it to him again.
Honestly. No, he's starting to cook.
Yeah. Oh.
They hand it off.
Yeah, no, they got hurt. They're probably going
to loss of
this kill some clock.
Yeah. Maybe just run this down to the fourth quarter with a minute 15 here to go.
I say they might. I want to give you a carry, Hugh.
Give me a carry.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's been last time I played football was 7th grade junior high, so.
Maybe they've seen the tape.
Maybe. You know, I did run track in high school. I was pretty good at it.
So you got the speed.
I do have the speed, yeah. I don't know if I have the lateral quickness, though, to make a cut, you know. Yeah. Might blow out a knee or something.
Offense. 5-yard penalty. The second down. Good
job. False start there on the Duhawks. I wonder if they're going to put in maybe some more younger wide receivers here. Maybe some freshmen get some reps in, or who knows.
Yeah. I'd bet.
Harrison, he's a sophomore. He's a fairly young player.
Yeah. The next receiver that would come out would probably be Marty, and they'd probably put a freshman in.
Sweezo!
Keeper! Was that Trevor Sweezo or Noah Sigworth? I couldn't tell.
I mean, honestly. It's like one of those pictures we gotta like spot the differences.
Yeah, it's like blurred my eyes real quick. Oh, Duhawk down.
Is that Sean?
It's never good, especially in a blowout.
Yeah.
Man. Ooh. Grabbing the knee, maybe?
You just gotta hope it's a cramp, maybe.
Yeah, hopefully. He's stretching out, so hopefully that's what it is.
Yeah. Always hate to see players get hurt whenever. As you can see here, ladies and gentlemen, a shot of the crowd.
Yeah, the fans are hyped.
The fans are getting into it.
Duhawk fans love their Duhawk football.
Gotta love Duhawk football. I mean,
yeah.
Gonna be starting the season off 1-0, undefeated. Mm-hmm. I mean, not a high switch. No, that was Sean.
He's able to walk off, though, so that's good.
Yeah.
That's always good.
I'm assuming Sean's day is probably going to be done after that.
Yeah, I tell you what, Sean's never one of those great guys on this Loras football team. Always a smile, always happy, always asking you how you're doing.
Yeah, I saw him out here about an hour and a half before the game. He was out there midfield just doing his stretches and everything and getting ready before. He's like one of the first guys out here on the field, and just I think it just shows how dedicated he is to this.
Yeah. Out of Florida. Oh, Sweezo going deep. What a catch! Oh, my gosh!
What a catch and a throw.
Was that Marty?
Sweezo's pass is complete to number 86, Marty.
It was! What Let's a throw go. And catch right there. I'm going to have to see the replay on this one. He just led him perfectly. Good pickup block there by the running back. Just a great goal. That was right in the basket.
Yeah, it fell right in the bread basket.
What a catch.
It's the end of the third.
Pretty dramatic way to end the third quarter, if I do say so myself.
Yeah. Dulocs are holding up their fours.
Yeah, they are. That quarter wasn't as, you know, as explosive as the past ones, but still scored, you know, so.
Yeah.
Had to keep on improving.
Had the coolest play.
It did.
Yeah. See, the Duhawk fans.
Probably two of the coolest plays so far.
Holding up the fours, yeah.
Duhawk fans know what's going on.
Shout out Johnny Quinn and Wild Bill right there and sitting in the stands holding up the fours. Look at Coach H on the sideline talking to the troops.
So inspirational.
Yeah.
I think the biggest thing the Duhawks have to worry about is keeping their head in the game here. Up with such a big lead, it's probably going to be hard to, you know, stay focused for these last 15 minutes.
Stay focused. Don't get hurt.
Mm-hmm.
I think Duhawks coming out in two tight end set right here. Yeah. Oh, give it to Willis. Look, no one's on him. Oh, never mind.
I think he can burn his man.
Yeah, give him over in the middle on a nice slant right here. Hand it off.
Oh,
Raddick.
Touchdown. His second touchdown of the game.
Too easy.
It was. I'm pretty sure he was almost untouched.
A lineman down. Please don't be hurt. He's good. Maybe. Hopefully.
And the Duhawks, when I was doing my scouting for this game, they only have 8 offensive linemen total.
Yeah. They're shorthanded.
They're really short, yeah.
See Justin
Is
Apple.
Is that Justin Apple?
Yeah, limps off the field. Hopefully he's okay.
Yeah. Especially after you made that nice play earlier in the game for the strip tackle.
Mm-hmm. It is the definition of a peanut punch that he had out there.
Oh, Zach with the kick.
Oh, touchback Talbot.
I think that ball might be into the next county, honestly. Yeah, I think he might have kicked it over the bridge into Illinois.
It went over the Mississippi. Gosh.
Here's the replay here. Good by number 16, Zach Talbot. Untouched? Oh, touch at the end, but.
He's already in the end zone.
Gotta love to see him have his second rushing touchdown of the game.
Mm-hmm. That was good. Seniors.
Mm-hmm.
Although I do think, if I'm not mistaken, when I last time I asked, every senior is coming back for a fifth year.
Ooh. That.
Yeah. That's going to be that's
huge.
Gonna be a nice season.
Yeah, it is.
Now, obviously, especially things could change.
Yeah,
so.
They could. But especially if that is true and it happens, especially with these freshmen and, like, Javon.
And then another freshman class coming in.
Be a scary team next season.
Nobody's going to want to see the Duhawks.
No. Who knows? Might not want to see the Duhawks at all this year either.
No.
Especially if they keep playing like this.
Yeah.
I mean, 58 on answered points.
It's going to be a long bus ride back for the Eagles.
Yeah, it is. Awfully quiet.
Yeah.
Zach's kick up. Oh.
Touchback Talbot!
Oh my goodness!
Touchback Talbot!
Touchback!
They call him that
for a nickname.
Yeah.
It looks like the freshman quarterback for the Duhawks, Garrett Hutchinson, got his. He's getting warmed up on the sideline.
Oh.
You can maybe see a little freshman QB action in here.
Let's go.
New quarterback in here for the Eagles, Colin Currier.
See if he can get anything going for the Eagles.
Yeah. Maybe if he can, then maybe Flanagan might not be starting next game, but who knows.
It is also against the Duhawk backups, though, to be fair.
Yeah, that's true.
There's a little something.
Currier looks like he's a, awfully quick quarterback too, just off of that. Even though he didn't take it, but
four and a half hour drive for the
Their longest 4.5 hours ever, honestly.
It's already 8:30, man. They're not gonna get back.
Wow, that's news. That's yikes.
I'll probably be out of here early as like 9:30.
Mm-hmm. Not fun. Mm-mm. Hands it off to his running back, who is met by a swarm of Duhawks once again. I mean, they're just all over the ball. James with the
carry, they're everywhere.
Again, yeah.
A gain of 2 to the 32. Third down.
It doesn't matter who's out there for the Duhawks. They're making plays. See number 31, Donald Patnode out there. Let's go, Don.
Eagles dropping back to pass. Moved out of the pocket. Oh, breaks his tackle and gets about back to the line of scrimmage.
That's a good move.
That was. Thought he was not, I thought he was about to be a sack, but shocked us and broke a couple tackles to do his best to not lose any yards.
To lead to another punt.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
I think they're going to do a fake punt.
Fake it. Fake it.
I mean, KJ Downey's the punter. He's one of their best athletes.
Yeah.
I don't know. Let's see something.
Ooh, oh, they did!
That's if it's not going to work.
Oh, rugby style punt.
Oh. I guess they faked us out on if it was a fake or not.
Well, it's a good call not to fake it because they had him dead to rights.
Oh, the freshman quarterback, Garrett Hutchinson, going to be getting some reps in here.
Let's go, Hutch.
Like to see it. So, obviously, a big lead here. How do you think the players to watch have been doing so far in today's game? Even though they're out now.
Yeah, Eli Thomas, he put on display. He quickly showed why he's the most dangerous man on the field and was an All-American. Mm-hmm. He did not seem to lose a step at all from tearing his ACL. Sam Jones, we haven't really called his name too much, but he's on the D-line. I was making a lot of plays. So, you know, sometimes it's just about eating up two blocks and letting someone else go free. And then Jack Foley shutting down every pass thrown to him.
Yeah. So, I mean, you're scouting for the players to watch. Solid.
Yeah.
That's why you're so trusted in these sports.
Oh!
Running the ball here for the Duhawks.
That's a great run.
About a yard short here of the first down.
It's number 19.
J.J. Weyer. Freshman.
J.J. Weyer.
Wow. Oh, that guy's talking about. They're getting the freshman in here.
Yeah.
Also, number 83, J.P. Jira, a freshman, is also out there. At wide receiver down at the bottom of your screen. Duhawks put a man in motion. They hand the ball off again to J.J. J.J. pushing forward for 5 yards.
Let's go.
Run the ball strong here.
J.J. Weyer with another carry. He's brought down
maybe this will lead to him possibly getting a few more reps in, more games down the road, maybe.
Maybe a third streak. Now over Thomas. Or
no.
Ty.
But then again, Radic has played well today, too, so maybe not.
This loaded running back position.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
run over a few defenders.
Pass is complete by number 10.
Kobe Novus.
Another freshman.
Pass was caught by number 22, Kobe Novus. Result of the play is the Loras.
Got a few freshmen out here right now for the Duhawks.
87, too. Jaheim Haynes.
Jesus, rocking all sorts of freshmen from Florida.
A lot of Florida kids on this Duhawk team.
I'm sure this winter was a shock on them with how bad it was.
Oh, yeah.
Duhawks handed it off here.
Last year, I had to give Sean one of my sweatshirts. Cause
oh, gosh. Because
he's from Florida, you know. He's so cold. I think he only had one jacket, so I was like,
probably wasn't Williams. A winter jacket, was it?
It was, but he didn't have one like, you know, like a sweatshirt like for lighter, you know. So I was like, I got you, Sean.
Such a good friend.
Oh, thanks, you.
Ooh.
Oh, keep the legs moving.
stood up and just.
Williams with another
about
carry.
Keeping the legs going. Edward Williams, sophomore.
Bus. They call him Bus for a reason.
5'6", 205. That's a big dude. That's
they call him Bus dude. For a reason.
I can tell.
You know?
Just keeps moving.
One of the first times I met Bus, everyone's like, man, why'd they call you Bus? He's like, because I run people over. That's all you need.
Living up to the nickname.
Yes, sir.
It was like Jerome Bennis.
Yeah.
Garrett gets the snap. Oh.
Fake.
Oh. Ooh. It was either a fake or
a sack.
Oh!
Did he catch it?
I think he caught that.
Wow. The freshman making some plays.
I honestly thought that play was a misread. I thought one of them went the wrong way on the handoff. And
I'd say almost 100% that's what happened.
Just good job by him to keep the play alive.
There is a flag. Probably
maybe
legal.
Lineman downfield.
Legal downfield, yeah, because it's definitely supposed to be a handoff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely supposed to be a handoff then.
Do you think Loras can put up a 60 burger?
Maybe. If they convert this third down here, I think they have a high chance of it.
It's going to be tough to convert.
I know.
Let's see. Come on, Hutch. Let's see it.
Let's see the cannon.
Yeah.
Let's see the arm.
Let's see it.
I think he can air it out. Win at his back, too. I mean, I think he can throw it into the end zone, honestly.
Yeah, throw it to Willis. Come on.
Yeah.
Give it to Niner.
I mean, I think we all want to hear EJ's reaction again if Harrison gets the ball. Give it to him. Oh.
Run.
Oh.
Bus. See, he runs people over.
Yeesh.
Hop on the bus. Everyone can take a ride.
Yeah.
Come on.
Number 28.
I think they're going to go for
Williams.
It.
Yeah,
down
you got
to. 32.
Let Zach kick it from here. See the
honestly, why not?
Test her out.
Yeah, he kicked it all the way into the soccer net last time.
Yeah.
So.
Let's see if Garrett's going to air it out here. Nope, they're going to hand it up. Oh, doesn't
first
matter.
Down.
He's going to get the first down.
Let's
and
go,
more.
Bus. Good run, Bus.
Williams with another carry to the 24-yard
starting to cook
line.
Right now.
Result of the play is the Loras College. First down.
He comes off the field after good work there by him.
Waiter comes back in. And Norris.
Duhawks getting the play in here from the sideline. 10 seconds left here on the play clock. Gear handed off to Kobe. Kobe making a few guys miss.
Decent
and pushing forward for a solid gain of 6 yards.
I'll tell you what, the guy who came off the edge there for the Eagles just completely whiffed.
Yeah.
I don't know who he was trying to tackle, but he got a whole bunch of air.
I saw him lined up, and I thought, it looks like there's going to be nobody there for to pick him up, but... He missed anyway, so. It almost has to be another run here, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Unless they're throwing a screen to my guy H.
Kobe spun forward there.
Close
picked
to the
up
first
a few
down.
Yards.
Uh-huh. Another rushing attempt for Novus. A gain of 2 to the 15-yard line.
Give Harrison a jet sweep. That could be a house call if he did get
it.
Yeah,
it could. I'd like to see it. I'd love to see it. Ooh, maybe we're in field goal range now in case we don't pick it up, though.
Oh, yeah, we are for sure, I'd say.
Do you think it'd be Farfan to come out there, or do you think it'd be Zach?
Well, I'm not sure about Talbot's range. I think Farfan could definitely nail this, but with Talbot kicking the last one, I think they might try him out there to see what he has.
Oh, passing it.
Was that H? Oh, no.
No, I don't think it was. I think it was...
Still a good play, though.
Number, I think it was JJ.
Hutchison's pass is complete to number 19, JJ Weyer. Result of the play is a first down.
Duhawk... Young guys just moving the chains.
Like to see it. Like to have these young guys get experience for next year or maybe 2 years from now.
Yeah.
especially for like Garrett, who's a freshman quarterback, probably a third string. So
yeah,
in a couple years, he'll have some experience from this, and maybe won't be as nervous when he gets his first start. Maybe. Oh, that play was just blown up there by the Eagles. Took a little too long to develop, and they just brought the house on that one.
22, Kobe Novus with the carry.
No, Hugh, these teams first met in 1975. Do you know what the score of that game was?
I do not. What was it?
The Eagles won 8-7.
Oh, my goodness.
Quite a different game.
What a barn burner.
Yeah, quite a different game.
I know. Jeez.
That was like a rock fight compared to this one.
Yeah, I know. I mean, the Eagles haven't matched their total from the first meeting yet, though.
Yeah.
Only at 6.
Yeah. They're on pace early on.
Yeah, they were. It looked like it might be a defensive game in that first quarter, but then the Duhawks just turned it on and ran away with it.
Yeah, really, really slow start for the Duhawks, but they flipped the switch.
Probably a false start.
Yeah, probably.
So the Duhawks' big lead, they've just really, their victory has been coming from like everything. Everybody's been contributing, and I think the biggest factor to it is the defense, really. I think that's what's been the key part for it. And then if you flip it over to the offense side, I think it's got to be Sigworth. He's played amazing today.
Yeah. Two early interceptions and not like did not bother him at all. He put those in his rearview mirror, able to run for two and throw for three. So I believe they're targeting Harrison right there, guy out of bounds.
It's just good to have a guy with the poise have the two early interceptions not affect him and come back and play amazing.
We also got to mention Ty Bosch had two touchdowns called back.
Yeah.
Still had some great plays.
Mm-hmm. He's just a hard guy to bring down.
Yeah.
Eli was making plays too, yeah.
I'd say we won the battle in the trenches too.
100%, yeah. I just remember one play that sticks out for me is in like the first quarter and we were down here on our own end and we all thought Eli got tackled and just broke free and ran for like 10 more yards.
Yeah. There you go, Bus. Oh, yeah, Bus.
Oh. Nice run there for the Duhawks.
A lot of kicking it.
Edward Williams, the Bus.
Fourth and goal.
Oh, who's coming up? It's Zach. Oh, this is almost like an extra point.
It's basically an extra point, yeah.
As Justin Apple runs off the field here.
It's good.
Up and good. 60 bomb.
60.
Field goal is good by number 16, Zach Talbot.
Score here with 5:05 left to go in the game. Your Loras Duhawks 61, Northwestern Eagles 6.
I wonder what's the largest margin of victory in Duhawk history.
We got to be getting close to it if we're not already at it.
This got to be top five.
It has to be.
See touchback Talbot up on the screen.
The bench is loving it, sounds like.
Yeah, they're yelling Apple's name. Pretty chilly out now.
It is, yeah. It's all dark out, the wind, open air booth here, blowing our notes all around with the wind.
Yeah.
Not a good combination.
Yeah. I said the only benefit of living in Roman's be you can look out your window and
watch football,
see the Rock Bowl, yeah. But also be bad sometimes because practices, you always hear the whistle blowing.
Yeah, and the speakers playing
all
that.
You're trying to do
stuff.
Homework or sleep or take a nap, all of a sudden you hear
the thing
music
is,
playing.
Like, I live in Beckman and I can hear like the speakers from here too. So
Elmac can even hear them. Yeah.
So. Might see another touchback here with the wind at his back too. Oh, does a little bit of a line drive kick, and he almost gets the touchback,
his
too.
Foot was, his foot was almost over the line.
Oh, he's got a hole.
Flag, maybe. Yeah.
That one's probably going to be coming back.
Talbot with the kickoff.
Wouldn't be surprised. He's had quite a bit.
Yeah, it has.
There's a penalty marker down on the field.
Even with the big blowout we have on our hands here, the crowd almost all stayed here for the remainder of this game.
Duhawk fans aren't giving up on the boys.
Loyal. Gotta like it, especially with how cold it got. I figured some people might have left with the big lead we have.
Mm-hmm.
Always hurting themselves. We get another good return, then another holding call, moving them back. Maybe next game I'll bring some gloves. My hands are getting a little chilly.
Hopefully.
Hopefully it won't be this
cold. It'll be earlier.
Yeah,
so.
It'll be a 1 o'clock game. Courier is still back there for the Eagles. Fakes the handoff.
Chucks it deep. He's got a man.
Oh, he has a man wide open.
He's going to take it to the house.
I believe that is Jamon Howard, number 83.
Finally, some excitement for the Eagles.
Yeah. And the Loras defender really bit on
the play action.
Yeah.
Fake. I think it was a freshman out there, so.
Yeah. I'm assuming a lot of these guys, I'm going to assume, are being freshmen out here now with the lead that we got here.
Yeah.
But they did pass the 8-point mark. From 1975,
yeah,
I believe.
Yeah.
I think they're going to go for two, or are they just going to kick it?
Yeah,
they're
going to
kick it.
Block that kick.
Another block kick?
I want to see him block it and return it.
Blake Mitchell, the kicker for the Eagles here. His most previous attempt, which is in the first quarter, was blocked by the Duhawks.
You think you can make this?
I think I got faith in him. Hopefully Blake doesn't let me down, though, for putting my faith in him. Something's going on here. Oh, some guy wasn't on the field. They didn't have enough guys on the field.
Delay a game.
They just took a delay a game.
Because they didn't have enough guys. Coaches aren't going to be happy about that one.
No, they are not.
You think you can make it, though, if you're kicking the extra point?
If I can make it?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't think I can make it.
Me and Olivia tried in sports challenge, and I got a little too cocky. Went one
you
for
did?
Three. Yeah, I had maybe the worst kick attempt of all time. Didn't even get off the ground.
Did Olivia beat you? Oh, she's a soccer player.
Yeah.
So
I did
she
go
had
one.
An unfair
she went two for
so.
Three. I went one for three.
That's almost an unfair advantage. She's a soccer player. Oh, did he?
Oh, he made
oh.
it.
Did he hit that off the upright?
Nah, that was the
same. Oh, it was? Well, like, I don't know if like it hit off the upright and then like bounced.
Yeah.
But yeah, just they're setting you up for failure going up against Olivia. Soccer player.
It's all right. I'm surprised. I had a better punt than her. That was surprising.
Cooking up anything for the sports challenge on this upcoming sports zone?
Yeah, we got the big old dodgeball game.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's for all the marbles.
How do you feel your chances are going to be in that one?
Well, I feel like I drafted a better team than Olivia, so I feel like we're going to win. You know, we got Josh Smith. Stud.
Yeah, yeah.
Joey Foley.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, come on now. Claire Brun.
Yeah.
Sammy Martin. Come on.
It's unfair.
Yeah. I mean, Alyssa Feinhauer.
Are you going to target Olivia in this
game? Oh, yeah, 100%. Yeah. She's the first one I'm going for.
Okay.
100%. Yeah.
What are you going to do if she gets you out first?
Probably cry. Probably cry.
And, folks, if you don't know what we're talking about, check it out on YouTube Sports Zone. It's our show that goes out every other Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
And it's anchored by EJ Greenberg and Olivia DeVries.
So, yeah. Big, big game.
It is.
Ty just takes a knee. Got some tricks up my sleeve coming up for that one.
Okay. No cheating, I hope.
Oh, no, come on. Okay. I'm a man of integrity.
Okay. Just making sure. Glad to know we have it on record now.
Yeah. So if I do cheat, then.
So what are you going to do if you predict a win here and then come on for Sports Zone? You don't pull out through with the win.
Losing is not an option.
Okay.
I'm going to give my team the best pregame speech. They're going to be moved to tears.
Oh, okay. Going to have them ready to run through a brick wall?
Josh Smith is the fastest, so he's going to run up there and get all the balls and roll them back to us, and we're just going to
start pegging them off one by one.
The only thing is, Olivia did – it's too long to get tackled right away. Olivia did draft her brother, who is a baseball player. So,
ooh.
Yeah, that's the only
– And Olivia DeVries right there is working the sideline camera for us today, as that's Adam Rodriguez, our sideline reporter, next to her. And Olivia's waving at us.
That's EJ's co-host for Sports Zone.
And until the dodgeball game's over, we're mortal enemies, I think.
Oh, okay.
I think.
So I'm sure you could barely look at her there on screen.
Yeah, like,
it's like, jeez. You just got to fuel it, you know? Just got to get ready for the dodgeball game, fuel it up. See where see what happens.
Rushing attempt again by Bauer. Tackled at the 27-yard line, third down.
Deluxe, third down here.
.335 here left to go in the game. You're at Loras Duhawks 61 and Northwestern Eagles 13. Garrett in there at quarterback, and I believe that's number 34.
I think it's Colton Bauer.
Yeah. It is, yes.
Oh, cut it to the outside.
Oh, nice spin move there for the first down to bounce off the defender.
That was huge to kill some more clock.
Another carry for number 34, Colton Bauer.
But the thing about college football is the clock does stop to move the chains and all that stuff. Yeah. I'm just kind of hoping, you know, maybe see a little bit of air out here. Air it out just one time. Maybe another flea flicker?
Yeah, come on. Let's see what Hutch has.
Yeah, let's see the arm. Yeah. Let's see what we're working with for a couple years down the line. Garrett hands it off again. Oh, big hole. Rolling forward there. First down. Two first downs in a row there.
Feed the beast.
Colton Bauer
just starting to take over here. First down. Looks like Sean's back in the game for the Duhawks on the offensive line.
That's good to see.
Yeah. Just got to hope everything goes well and doesn't get hurt.
Yeah.
Down with 2:30 left to go in the game.
It's tough when they have an eight offensive line and have to rotate them.
Yeah, it is. Garrett gets the snap from the pistol formation, hands it off. Oof. I believe that was Colton again, and he was met there about 2 yards down the line.
I think they should give Dirtz a handoff. Who's going to tackle him?
True.
That's everyone's just diving at that guy's ankles trying to tackle him. Yeah. Because if you go upper body or even lower body, he's running right through
you. Yeah, he is.
You just got to hope he would trip, honestly.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Garrett's going to air it out.
Good protection.
Oh. I believe that was the freshman J.P. Jira there. That was Garrett's intended target on the slant route. Going a little bit more into topics. Who were in the trenches today? I think it's pretty easy. I think the Duhawks have just been all over that. They've been working and grinding down there, and I think that's the key to this victory, honestly.
Hands down, the defensive line for Loras destroyed the offensive line of the Eagles.
Yeah.
And then I would say our offensive line also did better than their defensive line.
Yeah, our offensive line got better throughout the game.
Yeah, oh yeah. They got stronger as the game went on.
First quarter, I'm just going to chalk that up to the nerves. I think that's what
it is. So Farfan will punt. So Eagles have probably about 40-some seconds.
Oh, yeah, to maybe put up more points.
They should run a flea flicker.
They should. Air it out. I mean, they ran a little bit of trickery, and that's how they got their most recent touchdown.
Yeah.
Fake punt, maybe?
So, Duhawks just take to the delay of game. Maybe trying to give Farfan some more room.
Yeah.
So it doesn't kick a touchback.
Mm-hmm.
our fans got a pretty nice looking punt there. And I believe that is Caleb Sieben just catches it and runs it out of bounds to avoid the hit. With 35 seconds left to go here.
They could take a knee.
That's what I was thinking. I was about to ask you, do you think they're going to take a knee or do you think they're going to try and run a play maybe?
I think they should run one play, throw it up, and then if it doesn't work, take a knee maybe.
Yeah.
Eagles will not take a knee.
Looks like the Eagles are going to hand this ball off to their running back, Jeremiah Stanton.
Don't know if the Eagles are going to get another playoff. Yeah, it looks like they're going to try to.
Maybe we'll try and air it out here.
Yeah,
see if they can get something going. But the wind's gotten stronger as the nights progress too. So
yeah, it's blowing against them right now. Yeah. Didn't really have to sling it.
Mm-hmm.
Five. Last play. Are they going to snap it? Nope.
At the end of this game, your Loras College Duhawks 61, Northwestern Eagles 13. The Duhawks just played great tonight.
Yeah.
What won the game for us today? I'd say like Duhawk we talked defense. About the defense,
yeah.
They were just unstoppable tonight, and it really showed off in the scoreboard, only allowing 13 points in the first quarter and then in the fourth quarter. They keep playing like that, gonna win us games.
Yeah, they're gonna win every football game. Yeah.
The standout player, who do you think? Who are you gonna get that one out to?
That's a toss up. I'll go Ty.
That's what I was thinking.
So you're gonna go Ty too?
I'm thinking Ty too.
I'd say Ty and say you.
Yeah, Sigworth played really well.
Eli always up there.
Thanks for tuning in to today's episode, guys. Tune in Saturday, April 10th at 1 p.m., and we'll be live from right here in the Rock Bowl covering the Loras football team. We'll be taking on the University of Dubuque. That's one you won't want to miss.